Hi, Steve Shadowstep, Halfling Sorcerer. I was born in a rich part of Waterdeep, but tragically my entire family were killed by bandits when we interrupted them robbing our home. I survived by hiding in the cellar, and to this day I still feel safest hiding in small spaces. Escaping the bandits, I grew up on the streets and survived, not through trickery, but through performing magic tricks for coin.
Pickle is a bit of an oddball even by Gnome standards. She prefers to smash things instead of build them, and she'd rather do 1,000 push-ups than talk about like feelings or emotions or any of that kind of stuff. That being said, she's very loyal to those she feels have earned her trust. Her BFF is her battle axe, which she brings everywhere with her. Yeah, everywhere. Even the toilet.
La 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 la. Oh, hey, hello. I'm Pig, the wolf lover. Half-Orc bard whose love for music knows no bounds. Although shy, I gain courage by performing for the crowd and entertaining them. I'm fiercely loyal, and I hate it when you mess with my friends.
Okay, so we've ducked outside.
Yes.
And we're looking for a safe spot to rest.
Mm-hmm. Can we just do one round of the palisade? I just want to see if there's any like weak looking spot.
Okay, yeah, sure. Let's do that.
Yeah, you walk around the palisade. The palisade seems to be pretty constant. Like,
not any weak.
Yeah, you don't seem to spot any weak spots. You could
Can you climb it?
It's pretty high, but you could try.
Okay, let's go to a more secluded one, like behind the house or something, like that where there's no one walking around.
Okay, you find a secluded spot.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, and then let's attempt to climb the shit out of this.
Well, wait, do we do that before we are healed, or do we do that now?
I feel like resting in this town is going to be a bad idea.
Well, yeah, we can post-watch. Can we post-watch? Like, have one of us stay awake while the others rest and then
Could you rest and take watch at the same time?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, okay, let's find a place where we're not sleeping in the open. Like,
what's your hit point?
9.
Yeah, I'm on 6.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
And you all need your spells back, I think.
Yeah, we need our spells back. So, I'm thinking, yeah, is there a secluded spot when we're walking around the palisades? Do we see any secluded spots? Which is not like we're just taking a sleep in the street. Maybe it's under a bit of an overhang or something.
Yeah, it'd be pretty obvious, actually. Anyway, you sleep in a town.
Okay.
Are all the houses occupied?
Yes.
Okay. Damn it! I was gonna sneak into
just sneak into a house?
Yeah.
Well, we could go back into the inn and
try to sneak. Do you think you could ask the harp lady? Could we?
And we could ask harp. Well, the harp lady is infected like everyone else. She'll just tell us to go to the inn.
Oh, yeah.
So I think our options are sleep out in the open and people will know that
I'm wondering though, you know, she said the innkeeper was a dude, but then we went in there and there was a barmaid.
It was a barmaid. Yeah, we didn't meet the innkeeper.
Yeah.
And she made the creepy reference that we'd be back.
Yeah.
So, personally, I would rather sleep on the street and then have to fight than be pulled into a trap of some description in the bar.
We could go to the inn and sleep there while keeping an eye out.
That's true. That's true, but it's their home ground if they've got any traps set up. Like if they put us in the room which you can't open.
Oh, yeah.
Just step through here and then the door closes and there's no handle.
Right, so for our audience, I'm sorry about the sound just now. Just to summarize the events leading up to this point, in case our sound has screwed up any narration going on so far. The three of them have found themselves. The trio stepped through a portal in agreement in exchange for Lord Osborne's golden rose, because they are sent to discover what's behind this portal and go back and report to Shalza in order to get back the golden rose. The trio of them have landed in this village, which is a very happy village. Everybody is smiling. They think that something's wrong. I don't know why. Everybody is giving them a creepy smile and everybody seems really joyous. And the sky is red.
Okay.
Alright, so what do you guys think? Sleep outside or sleep in the inn?
I think inn.
Sleep in the inn,
yeah.
Alright, done. All right, let's go.
Okay, we head back to the inn.
The same barmaid is still cleaning the
same,
mug.
Exact same mug.
same rogue.
She's like, welcome.
Yeah, this is so creepy.
Yeah.
Alright, I walk over and say, we'd like to stay for an evening.
Experience sure. Your hospitality.
And she looks at Pink and she looks at you're using a violin, right?
Yeah.
She looks at violin. She says, would you like to pay the usual fee or would you like to perform for your stay?
Perform for
we would love to bring some happiness to this town.
More happiness. Residence.
More happiness is always better.
She's so creepy.
Nice.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So she gives you keys to a room. You go upstairs, you find your room number. It's a pretty standard room, a bed and table and a closet, whatever. The three of you can share.
You check for traps. Check for traps.
There's an extra large bed which the three of you can sleep on because two of you are pretty small. Mm. You can check for traps, sure.
All of us check.
Investigate, check. So the three of you start like feeling your hands around the room.
Shit, not bad.
Putting your ear to the ground.
Investigate.
Oh, plus nothing. 15? 19 plus 0.
4.
Right, so as the two of you are investigating a room, Steve is just sitting there staring at the ceiling.
Whistling to myself.
Yeah. I'm looking for traps in the ceiling. The two of you find nothing.
Okay.
The room is pretty normal, there are no traps.
Do we have time to do the short rest?
Long rest, you need long rest for yourself, but we have to sleep.
Hey Rusia, is the audio working now? Is it okay now? Yeah, okay, there'll be a bit of delay.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Can we do a long rest?
Yeah, do we have time for a long rest before the performance?
Long rest before the performance, no.
Short rest, yes.
Okay.
Let's do that. Yeah, let's do a short rest. I'll use one of my hit dice.
Okay, I'll do the song of the rest.
Yeah. Extra d6, right?
Song of the Plains.
I will use my hit dice as well.
Okay.
One of them.
Yeah.
Alright, so...
additional plus D6?
D6.
Shit.
Okay.
Oh my god. You've got two?
Wait, oh. It's not
two and six.
Everybody.
So. Oh, it's not your roll?
Do I roll it? As in I'm the only one that rolls it? Or everybody rolls it?
For the song of the rest. You guys can roll yourselves.
Okay.
Let's add a D6, right? Every time you roll a hit dice.
Yeah. Okay.
So which hit dice is it? Apologies.
Do I need to roll this?
D6.
Mine's
a D6. Yeah, so you can roll an additional D6 because Pink is singing the song of the place. Song of rest.
Okay, so
good. Thank you.
Two. Oh wait, D8.
There you go.
Thank you.
Just roll these two. Like that. Oh, nice.
6. 11.
Plus 11.
11. 25.
You know what the song of the place sounds like?
What was that?
So I'm back to
the
night sky. Fuck off! Oh my god, please save us.
Stop.
I'd rather have the creepy smiles there.
Yeah.
How did I know it wasn't going to be a pleasant song? Yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
I'm almost at full health, that's great.
I'm full.
I'm like slightly past half, but it's fine.
Okay.
You guys feel hungry and thirsty?
I don't want to eat the food.
You're thirsty because you don't have water, you're looking at a fountain and...
Wait, I got water skin, guys.
Alright, you have water skin.
I have 10 days worth of rations.
Okay, you can eat those.
Yeah, okay,
But your water skin...
How long is it going to last?
It's going to run out. It doesn't last forever.
Oh, guys, pee into the water skin again.
No!
You can recycle your fluid. What goes in comes out.
No, again. No.
Well, if it's a choice between drinking the happy water and drinking urine, it's a tough one. But so you're saying that the water skin can we use it for a one-off?
It's running out.
Okay, it's running out. Right.
But we're no longer hungry, no longer thirsty.
Yeah,
it's like okay.
Okay, how about if I take a drink first, so then you can see what happens to me.
But you're our singer, and you're about to perform.
And you're our music maker.
No, after the performance. After the performance and then I will drink it, and then let's just see how it goes.
And
I
mean, also, you're our healer.
Yep, he's pointing that out.
Okay, so then who
I should drink it, because I'm the least critical. You guys can do
also,
damage.
Also, he has no more spells left.
And I'm low on spells, I've got one
so,
spell.
So like, he won't be able to fireballs or anything.
Okay, cool, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So you
I'll
try first.
It
first,
yeah.
we'll live on the one, that was low on the scale.
Yeah, we just slap him out of it.
And if I'm, yeah, if I'm getting silly, just knock me out.
God. Okay.
Alright.
Yeah, so it's time for performance, yeah?
Well, are you drinking the water?
No,
yeah,
after
the
performance tonight.
Yeah, the performance is going to make you, the three of you, really thirsty. Definitely. Because
we
it's exertion and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, we go downstairs, there's nobody.
There's no one to perform
for.
There's no one to perform for. And the barmaid is still there, and she's like, are you ready to begin your performance?
Tell you what, you guys don't have to do anything. Y'all
yeah,
will
just
scout
just
shit. Okay,
chill.
Tell
super chill.
I will just sit there and I will just play my violin. That's it. I think
okay.
This should be fine.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wait. Do you want to start drinking or you don't want to yet?
Well, it depends how thirsty I am. If I'm gonna pass out, yeah, I'll drink the water.
Okay.
But if I'm still okay to just sit here until the end of the performance, I'm happy to wait until you finish. Because I'm kind of like the two of you ready when I'm gonna drink. If
okay.
You're in the middle of the performance, it seems like a bad idea.
Okay, since I'm gonna perform, I wanna cast invisibility on one of you so that you can go and find out what's creepy in this inn.
The performance starts at about 7
what
p.m.
Time, what time is it now?
Hmm?
What time is it?
7 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah, so
okay.
I'll distract with the performance or whatever it is.
I'll go check out the fountain.
Wait, who's.
Wait.
I'm more sneaky than you
Someone
are.
Someone needs to
then.
Sneak, okay? So.
Yeah.
Can,
yeah, the
can,
last time, the last time people
you
went
said,
invisible,
you, the time you sent me, it was
yeah,
a shit show.
It was a disaster.
Okay, shit show. Okay, so you'll go find out the fountain. So can we three all be doing the
no,
fountain?
I'll stay with you in the inn.
And I'll sneak.
Yeah,
somewhere.
And you'll sneak. Okay,
where would you like me to go? Because
behind
the
counter.
We had a look a bit. We had a look at the fountain earlier, and we knew it was magic.
No, as in I'm walking on within the inn itself.
Sure, I'm happy to go exploring.
Yeah, go upstairs and then go behind in any. Is there secret rooms and stuff?
We don't know yet.
Okay. Okay. So there's a room behind her, like.
Oh no, there's no secret room. There's like a shelf with your very standard ale and beers, whiskeys.
And when we were going upstairs, did we see any other stairways or floors that we didn't explore?
No.
You reckon?
Yeah, she has a kitchen behind her, but there's nothing much. The door is open. You can see it's a pretty standard kitchen, very clean.
No trapdoors on the floor.
No, until you go in there.
Not until you go in there. I don't think there's any chance of you going inside the kitchen. Unless you're invisible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, so. Do you reckon it's worth it? I'll do some sneaking.
Let's go back up so you don't turn invisible in front of
yeah.
Me.
Sure.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, okay. Okay, so we go back up and then I turn.
Turn
Steve
invisible.
I'm gonna make a Steve shaped lump of pillows in the bed, cover with a blanket, and then we go down. Yeah,
okay.
And then we go down.
Make a dexterity check.
Oh,
see how accurate you are. Your Steve shaped last
7.
Yeah.
Come on, one of you guys help me out.
I think you did a great job, so you guys came down.
Oh shit.
Come on, they didn't see me doing this and they're
like,
we trust you. Oh god.
Oh, that's terrible.
Could help out.
So, do I need to roll anything to check how invisible I go?
No.
Okay.
Just cast it. Okay.
I'm just invisible.
Yeah, so you gotta
go
in.
Pink wall.
I will sit on
the
stool and
start playing
the violin.
What kind of songs are you gonna play?
It's gonna be, an upbeat song with a bit of singing.
Okay.
Little bit. You wanna save your thirstiness.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Okay, no singing.
Just like elevator music.
No,
she's playing elevator music.
Yeah. So okay.
Sure.
Yeah. Alright, so I just Okay. Okay, so I'm just sitting at a stool there. I'm playing the violin. It's an upbeat song. Pickle's nearby.
Sitting nearby. Should we tell her that he's up there? No, just don't draw attention to it.
Yeah, don't.
She
yeah,
asks,
then,
okay.
That's all. Then,
and
yeah,
I,
stay
I,
okay, so where would you like to go?
So first of all, I would like to How much, is there enough space around her that I can pass without brushing
her?
Yeah, sure.
You can just climb over the counter, get behind her, she'll
meet you. So I check out the kitchen first.
Yeah, check out the kitchen. Kitchen's nice and clean. You want to make an investigation check to search for trapdoors and cranium rats and stuff like that.
18?
18.
Yep.
You find a nice wedge of cheese tucked away in one of the shelves.
I take it, but I put it in a very specific pocket so that I know that that's the, that could be the bad thing.
Poison cheese.
Man, I'm hungry.
Yeah. Exactly. Like, I make a mental note, poison cheese, left pocket. Poison cheese, left pocket. Poison cheese, yeah, that's
all. It doesn't seem to be poison at all. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just a, in fact, all the food seems pretty decent there. Like garlic cloves, meat.
Take some.
Is there any magical...
Do you sense...
Yeah, do I sense any magic on any of this food?
Make an arcana check.
My arcana is not horrible. 11.
You sense a thin trace of magic, but it isn't coming specifically from the food. It's emanating from...
Everywhere.
Yeah, it's just very mild magic.
Okay, so yeah, I pocket just a few items. Enough that it's not going to be like my pocket is bulging, but just some stuff which is getting... The things which are most likely to sustain us if we're hungry.
Okay.
So garlic, it's hard to eat garlic, but cheese and whatever ration, like if there's any...
Cram a whole clove of garlic into your mouth. Hi!
You're breathing on people.
I don't think she can keep that smile out there.
Yeah. Hello! Kidding.
So what sort of items can I grab and put in a pocket that'll be
just
not
like
so
obvious? Meat, maybe not apples.
Meat,
fine.
Cheese.
Meat. So I grab some meat and cheese.
Okay.
Put it in my pocket.
Yeah.
Where else can you go? Check upstairs.
I didn't check. I didn't
see
any trapdoors or anything.
No.
Okay. So I come back out.
Okay. As you leave the kitchen, you notice that she's looking at the entrance, and as you climb over the counter, she looks at you.
Like makes eye contact.
Yeah, she is.
Oh my god!
And she goes back to cleaning her mouth.
What the fuck? That's
crazy!
I put my hand in front of my face, so like... I can't see my hand, right? I can't see my hand, but she can see me. Alright. So I go back to you guys and I go, guys, I just say it. She can see me.
What the hell?
Like, a disembodied voice says to them, guys.
I'm just like, go do something.
Well, oh my god!
Yeah, you're still performing, so I just tell you. She can see me. What do you want me to do?
Oh god, maybe we should have checked whether she could see you before we sent you into the kitchen. Okay.
She saw me steal from her. Did she actually? Was she looking into the kitchen when I was stealing stuff?
No.
So she didn't see me. She just knew that I climbed into the kitchen and came back out again.
Yeah, she does. When you went in, she didn't do anything, but when you came out, she made eye contact again and kept eye contact throughout, smiling all the way.
Okay. Well, they don't seem to mind when you steal from them. That's good to know.
So up until this point, there have been nobody who has entered the inn.
Wow. And who are you performing for? No one.
Nobody. I'm just at
the best performance ever.
I'm just earning our keep, man. Just stay at this place. Yeah.
Are you going to do anything else? Or?
You got a whole hour.
Well, okay. So I just come over and chat with you.
Yeah, I don't
understand.
Go upstairs, check.
She saw me. Doesn't seem to have raised any alarm bells. I'm just going to go upstairs anyway and just have a look around.
Yeah, just be careful.
Yeah. Alright, so keeping very careful watch, now that I know that people can see me, I go back upstairs, I check room by room. And like whatever doors open, without really testing anything, I would look at whatever doors are open and see if I see anything.
The entire inn is empty. All rooms are exactly the same.
Okay.
Oh,
they have the exact same format, down to the specks of dust. Exactly the same, unless you disturb them.
Wow.
And as you walk by as you check your room, your room has been formatted back the same way. The pillows that Pickle has used to disguise as you have been laid back. You have not seen the bunny go up the room as you are performing.
Oh, this
but your belongings
so
are still there, no worries.
Okay.
So creepy.
So
creepy
this place is magical. Obviously I come back and I'm going to tell you guys, but before I do...
Sorry, as you enter the last room,
okay,
you see a man sitting on the bed. And he's just staring directly at you and smiling.
Eye contact again.
Yeah, you open the door, he sees the door open, he sees you.
Alright, so I'm at this point, I'm trying to decide whether I run back and grab friends before having a conversation or if I just launch into a conversation.
No, you're still invisible.
I'm still invisible.
I'm not sure if he sees you or okay. He's just staring at his face.
Okay, I step to the right and see if his eyes travel with me.
No.
They don't?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So he hasn't necessarily seen me.
Oh.
But the door did open in front of him.
Yeah, yeah, but... Okay, it wasn't like the wind just blew it open. It was like...
It could be.
It could be.
Make a wind on.
I used prestidigitation to make the sound of wind.
Yeah, he looks out the window and he looks back at
was you. The window open?
The window is closed.
No, but it could have come down the corridor. Like I just made the sound of wind coming in. Alright. In which case this guy. Alright, well I just look around the room now. I don't step too far into the room.
Same exact room. That's the rest of the 12 rooms.
What does he look like?
Yeah, what is he?
He has nice slick back black hair, short. His skin is rather pale, his eyes are sunken. He's wearing like these black suspenders with a white button-down shirt. They're like some kind of farm boy.
Okay.
Yeah, he's in his mid-20s. Does
he look like he's blind? When you say staring off into space, is he...
No.
Is he, okay.
He's definitely not blind.
Okay. Well, I reckon I'm just going to come and tell you guys.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be doing anything. There's no book. There's no, like, nothing. The room is
so
dark.
So creepy.
Except for the moonlight. He's just sitting up on the bed, just staring at you.
I can't charm him. I don't have any spells left. Otherwise, I will. So
I don't think
Chan
would have worked on that, man.
No, it's worth a shot, but it's I don't have enough spells, I can't. So I'm just going to come back to you guys.
Okay. Has the performance ended?
Yeah, the performance has ended at 8 p.m. and your visibility spell wears off.
Yeah. I tried to time it so that I was in the room when it wears off, and then I walk back downstairs.
Okay, so the barmaid puts down the mug. She does this.
I think.
And then she goes back and cleaning the mug.
That's awesome.
Are they robots?
I know.
No, but I don't think so.
And then you hear this faint...
From upstairs?
From upstairs.
Oh
from
god!
From where the guy's room is.
Oh shit!
And then you hear a faint clapping sound from the rest of the tunnel.
Oh god!
And everyone is clapping their hands in unison and then it stops.
Wow!
Oh, creepy!
This place is cool.
And she's like... It's time for bed!
Okay! I grab them and I'm just gonna drag them up with a smile fit to my face. We go back to the room. I'm like, guys, okay, we need to rest as like the shortest long rest possible, and then we need to get the hell out of here.
Except we need to drink water. So I'm gonna drink it first.
Yeah, he's gonna test it.
Should we just rest before we drink that?
Can we? Will we faint?
No.
Yeah, I'll be fine. Think
drink
yeah.
What?
Can we take the shortest long rest possible?
Before we drink
shortest
water is the question.
Yeah, so we wake up in the now it's like 8 p.m. Can we rest for 6 hours and at 2 a.m. we leave the inn?
Sure.
Okay.
Because it's the inn, you can sleep for
as long as you want. Okay.
Like maybe after about 3 hours, I'll just allow it that you have rested well. Because you guys have had a pretty uneventful day.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome.
So we're back at 4.
So are you just gonna pump on the bed and then rest for 6 hours?
No, we're gonna take turns.
Yeah, we
keeping watch.
Yep.
Yeah.
Who has the 6 hours, I assume it'll be 2 hours shifts.
Yeah.
Who has the first shift, second shift, and third shift?
First shift.
Wait, what's your health like?
Oh, it's 17.
Okay, I'll do first shift.
Okay.
Because I've got 22.
Okay.
And I've still got spells left, so I think you guys should be.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
I had the lowest, so.
First shift,
yeah.
Second shift.
Yeah.
Third shift.
Okay, all of you get the benefits of a long rest.
Okay, so we're back. Did
yeah.
anything happen during our shifts?
Just figure out the long rest thing.
Okay, so I got all my skills back.
Got all your spells back.
Yep.
I have nothing to fill up. Yeah, okay.
Nice.
Okay, so Pink first shift, second shift is Steve.
Yeah.
And Pickle last.
Yep.
Last shift.
So well, Pink, was I last? Because
no,
I
have
the least health. So I don't know.
Oh, fine, then I'll go second.
Alright, it doesn't really make any difference.
Wait, hold on, you mean two people are awake at the same time? Or
two people are sleeping at the same I'll take second shift, you take third shift, okay? Done.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, so even as you do your shift, you're considered resting because you're just sitting there.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Pink, during your shift, you hear nothing except the sounds of Steve and Pickle snoring. And 2 hours is up, you wake Pickle up, Pickle wakes up, groggy. And towards the end of your shift, Pickle, you hear a very loud womp come from where the fountain is supposed
womp
to be, yeah. Like, you know, like when the lightsaber is being pressed.
Oh my god.
Yeah, like womp. Good description.
Can I look out the window and see if there's anything?
You can't see the fountain from your window.
Okay, it's not facing the fountain.
Facing
the other side.
Yeah. And as you hear that, you also hear some... Okay, can you make a perception roll to see how much you hear?
14 plus 3, 17.
Oh wow, okay, you hear footsteps.
I wake the two of them up.
And you hear some scrabbling on the door.
Okay, I shake the two of them.
The two of them wake up.
And I push the door shut.
Yeah, the scrabbling just becomes loud scratching like...
I'm a zombie movie, you guys!
So,
okay, they're awake. Okay. The scrabbling's still continuing?
Yeah.
Oh my god!
So...
make a strength check.
I think you can go first.
Ah,
they're scrabbling on the door. Yeah. Pico is holding up the door, you are sitting in a bit. Steve is...
I jumped up.
Just woke up.
Yeah, rubbing my eyes.
I wake up fast.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh shit, I have no idea what to do.
I'm so creeped out.
You spend your time saying, what's going on?
Like,
what intonation?
What the hell? Hang on.
Okay,
I don't have enough skills.
Face the zombie apocalypse.
Can we? Are there any holes in the door that we can look through and see what's scrubbing at it?
No.
Perfectly.
Scrubbing gets all over.
Oh god.
All right.
There's only the door and the window. No other exits in the room.
Yeah, the window is closed unless you all wanted to leave it open.
No, I'm happy with it closed.
Look, check outside the window. If the townspeople are still there.
Are you just standing there? Yeah. Oh god.
No,
you can see the palisades and the rest of the town sleeping quietly. You look down and you see something, this bulbous, disgusting humanoid figure who is rotting.
Oh,
it looks like this. I'm gonna show it to you.
Alright, man, killing floor.
Yes.
Creepy.
I'm not sure if you
I'm ready for this.
Here. Yeah. You see three of these just climbing up towards the window.
Oh shit, I'm shutting it!
Three of them.
Yeah, you shut it.
Okay.
You get one more spore, it's visible. You get one more spore action before you end your turn.
God, do you think the townspeople turn those things at night? I don't know, man. Three of them? I mean, there should be way more than that. I think three of them and then some more at the door.
Yeah, there's definitely one, there's at least one at the door.
Oh, crazy.
Open the door and then you'll see Gandalf.
He'll be there to help us, for sure.
Can I just like...
shit your pants.
Can I just skip a turn and then move on to the next person?
So Pink spends a turn shitting her pants.
It went cold brown.
And Steve's turn.
I go away from, like, to a spot that I can see both the window and the door.
Okay.
So that whichever one opens first, I can be ready to attack.
Okay.
And I'm going to ready a spell.
When something comes through.
So that when something comes through. But I won't actually do it. Specifically, Firebolt.
Firebolt.
Yeah. So that I can target an individual as opposed to a group.
Okay, cool.
So I'm readying my Firebolt.
Alright.
Okay.
You're ready and... Pickle, can you make a strength check?
It's on the side. Can I re-roll that? It's like tilted.
Oh yeah, re-roll it please.
15 plus strength, 2 plus 2 plus 4, 19!
Okay. The scrubbing stops and you hear this you feel this loud thumping on the door, like pom pom pom, but you manage to keep the door shut.
Good work.
Not sure if that's gonna help considering you're pretty much trapped in this room, you guys.
No, but yeah. then we're only dealing with one person coming in the window instead of
both. Yeah, the wind. At this point, one of these beings just smashed through the window, right? And he just squeezes himself through the window. Yeah, and Steve unleashes a fireball on him.
Hit 13.
Yeah, okay, 13 is fine. You hit.
Great.
Any room for the damage?
Yep, 2. Hang on, it is just 1d10, right?
Yeah, it is just 1d10.
That's what I thought. 2.
Right, this bulbous humanoid figure goes, and then your fireball erupts from your hand, it connects with him, and you see it just. Yeah, it seems to have caused some damage, but most of it seems to have dissipated harmlessly against this creature.
And do I know whether that was just because I made a mistake casting it?
No, it's the creature's resistance.
It's got no resistance?
Yeah.
So, resistance to fire.
Yeah.
Guys, resistance to fire!
Or maybe just magic.
One of them lumbers over to Pink, who's shitting her pants.
Yeah, what the hell? I'm screaming, man!
The first one, he claws at you. He misses, he manages to dodge out of the way. Two more climb into the building. One of them goes towards Steve and one of them goes towards Pink. So the one attacking Pink hits.
Oh!
4.
Oh no.
But he manages to hit like a soft spot on you, so you take 11 points of damage.
Oh, holy shit, that's half a life!
He can't, yeah, he kills you, like you dodge wrongly.
Oh, man.
Basically, a critical hit. So anyway,
critical!
The other one lumbers towards Steve, and you see his clawed hands come towards you, but you manage to duck out of the way.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, the door is just pounding away.
I can't leave the door to attack though, because like then someone...
Yeah, you're like holding up the door.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you prop it with your back so your feet are against it?
It's like when you enter the toilet without your knock, you have to like hold it and pee.
No, I was wondering if you could throw something. Like if you've got your back against it and you're...
I don't do that much damage to my throne stuff though.
Better than nothing.
True. Oh, okay. I'm gonna go into a rage first off.
Okay.
Bonus action rage.
You guys hear Happy Girl scream?
Okay. I'm gonna fling my javelin at the one attacking Pink, because Pink's injured, yeah?
Okay, so you use your little bomb to...
I'm just gonna like...
You just press against the door and throw your javelin.
Okay.
There's very little room for you to maneuver, so...
Fine, maybe hand axe then.
Yeah, it's fine. You can throw your javelin. Okay.
Hey.
20!
Yeah, somehow you managed to lock the javelin at the right angle and hit.
Yes! Okay.
Are you going to hit the injured one?
The injured one?
Yeah, there's one slightly injured.
Did the one attack Pink?
Yeah, the one that attacked Pink.
Yeah, that one then.
Your javelin lands on him.
Yeah, 1d6. I roll 2d6, right?
Hmm.
5 plus 2, 7. That's not very much.
Yeah, the javelin sticks in the thing's neck. It plunges through that thing, but it's still standing. It's like, and it bubbles. Some green blood starts bubbling out. Pink's turn.
Man, this looks really bad. All three of them are in the room already, right?
Yeah, two of them are actually attacking you. Yeah, they're all in the room.
Yeah, you can't move away without getting attack of opportunity, so...
Dude, I'm going to cast sleep, man.
Okay.
And they might have more. Okay, then just
whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, shit. Sorry about that. Let me see.
Sleep.
Roll 5d8.
You're gonna need d8. D8.
D8.
Okay.
D8.
D8. Thank you. No,
that's
enough. Give you 5. Yeah. Roll these. Okay. Ah! You can do it. Ah!
I'm
really
picking up my butt. So that's a 12, 17, 20.
12, 13.
20. Alright, you managed to put the
21! 21!
21.
6, 12. 10
plus
9. 12 plus 8, 21. 20 and 1. 21. Keep quiet.
10 plus 9 is 21. Alright, 21, you managed to put all three of them to sleep. They seem to deflate a little and they go,
Okay, good, guys, do some shit.
Can we get the waken up guy that's banging on the door and then take care of those three?
Well, how much does it take to wake up these guys when they're asleep? Does
any damage?
But no noise.
Done.
Open the door.
Okay.
Steve's turn.
That's my turn. In which case, I ready a chromatic orb specifically, and I don't make it fire. I make it acid.
Okay.
But again, I do it in such a way that when the door opens, Pickle's not going to be in the way when I launch my chromatic orb.
Sure.
That's pretty much it. So I just sort of get out of the way so that I'm not going to hit the others as well.
Okay. Hold on then.
Hold on.
Yeah, you're holding the door. Awesome.
Spoiler. Yeah. Make another strength check with disadvantage this time because you're not using your bomb.
Oh, that's a 19, which would have been great. And a 2. Plus 4.
You feel the door burst open as the being behind you just shove it.
Just like, I roll forward.
Yeah, you just roll off to the side and this other creature emerges.
Not the same one.
It's not.
Oh! I readied my chromatic orb for no reason.
Resistant to acid.
Yeah, resistant to acid.
It seems like a green ape with a pig's face. Well, it looks like this.
Ew.
Green ape with a pig's face.
Yeah, have we encountered these monsters before?
Nope, not in your life.
You
can roll a intelligence check to three of you.
Okay. Intelligence check.
Natural 20.
5.
It's
not very
15 plus 5. So, even though you roll a 20, you don't really know what they are called, but you have seen these beings before in Sigil. They tend to cluster around the lower ward. They are demonic beings. They are from, they're demons from the abyss.
Okay, demons from the abyss. Well, obviously, I'm still waiting.
So, from your knowledge, from your vast studying, arcane knowledge, you know there are devils and there are demons. Devils are lawful creatures. And demons are chaotic.
And this guy's a demon. Alright.
These guys are all demons.
Okay.
And they seem to be kind of lesser demons. Like, they're not the really powerful, like, overlord of hell, like, demon god kind of shit.
Not Diablo.
It's Diablo! Diablo's the devil.
Oh, damn it.
Okay, that was super nerdy. Anyway, this thing just bursts in and he goes, and then he starts up. Yeah, your chromatic orb starts.
Gets
hurled at him.
Yeah, so the acid.
Could you roll for your attack?
25.
That's very good. Can you roll your dice twice?
Roll my dice twice?
Yeah, so that's 3d8 twice.
Okay.
Do you need 68?
I need 3d8. Oh, yeah, I can just roll it twice. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, yeah. We have 68 total.
Oh, we'll do all 6.
Yeah.
Alright, fine.
Wait, one more?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is
8?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Holy shit.
Two ones?
11, 16, 17, 20. You dealt 20 damage.
Brilliant.
Yeah, you muster up your green acidic orb and then you fire it at this thing. The acidic orb lands straight in his chest and it just dissolves through his chest and passes through to the other side and the demonic being just falls flat on the ground.
Hey!
Nice.
Yeah, behind him there's another one of those bulbers.
Oh, does it go in a straight line?
No, it doesn't. As he falls, you see acid as another barbarous humanoid being. It's not smart enough to wake up its compatriot.
Okay.
It lumbers towards the person with.
I'm right in front of them though.
Yeah, but the door has pushed you and you fell on the floor. Then it lumbers towards you.
Yep.
And it tries to claw you, but you manage to step out of the way and it pickles the.
Okay. I'm just gonna, like. You know how in The Shining it's like, here's Johnny!
Yeah.
But like, not actually smashing through the door because that's impolite. I'm just gonna go around the side and just like.
That's awesome!
Yeah. Okay.
Here's
Pickle! Pickle! Okay, so I'm gonna wait. There's just one more guy left outside, right?
Okay. Here's Pickle! X.
14 plus 4.
Okay.
Did I hit?
Yeah.
Okay. So 1d10.
So Pickle goes, let me ask you a question.
6 plus 2. 8 damage.
Okay, you do 8 points of damage. Your X, this is the guy.
Plus 2 because melee weapon and I'm raging, so that's 8 plus 2, 10 damage.
That's 10, so this is the guy that just came in, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you smash your X into his back, you feel your axe satisfyingly lodge into his back, and you pull it out, and he just collapses on the ground.
Hell yeah.
With green blood just spewing out of his back. Yeah,
and he died?
He dies. And two more sleeping. One heavily injured one in front of you, then two others sleeping.
Get the injured one.
Yeah, let's get the injured one. Yeah.
Shit,
let me see. What should I do?
You can just attack it. Most likely you'll kill it.
Rapier.
You can make an attack with advantage.
Okay.
So roll 2d20s. 2d20s.
Yeah.
Oh, 18 and
yeah,
a 4.
Yeah, you kill it. You skewer your rapier through his face.
Hey,
nice.
Good work.
Okay.
So now we're just left with the sleeping ones, right?
Yeah,
two sleeping ones.
Two sleeping ones?
Yep.
Can they talk? Do they seem intelligent enough to talk?
Yeah, let's just kill them. Yeah, don't kill them alive.
Yeah, okay.
Alright, in which case, any damage I do is going to wake it up, so I don't want to do too weak of an attack.
It should change it, right?
Yeah.
I want to give them bardic inspiration.
For sleeping targets?
No, it's fine. I think just do like a fireball.
Okay, fine. Guys, don't miss.
Well, fireball doesn't do much damage, though.
Yeah, but it's an auto crit. Because he's sleeping, right?
Ah, it's a crit?
Yeah.
It's great. Yeah, fireball then.
Okay, you put your hand to his face and you will unleash your fireball.
So I don't need to roll attack, right?
Yeah, you need to.
You need to.
Ah,
I do. Yeah, any attacks that hit?
14.
19. 14 plus 5.
Yeah.
19.
Yeah, let's see. Unconscious attack rolls have advantage. Yeah, if you hit.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
14.
19,
yeah.
So,
okay, roll 2d10.
2d10s.
Yeah.
These are d10s, yeah. 7, 9.
16, yeah. You blast unholy fire in his face, boom, and he wakes up. Oh, he's not dead yet, but it seems close to dying. It's like burning.
Okay.
King's turn.
Pink. It's my turn.
Pickle's turn.
Yeah. I'll get that. I'll. Huh. Okay, actually, could you get. I think I could take out the one in one hit, the sleeping one.
Mm-hmm.
So, your turn next, you take the other one.
Okay.
You run up to the sleeping one and
attack with advantage, right?
Yeah, you smash your axe into its skull. Okay, go for critical hit.
13 and I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
19. Yeah, okay. So 2d10. Where's my d10? 10 and 6 plus 4.
Alright, you just cleave your axe through the thin skull and it goes squatch and it dies. There's a burst of green blood.
Disgusting!
On your face. Yep.
Pink.
Okay.
Pink, your turn.
My turn.
Now roll d20 with your rapier, right?
Is he still? He's awake?
He's awake.
Very damaged.
It's like
God.
On fire.
I can do it.
Looks pretty scary.
Oh my god.
5 plus 4, 9.
He's very fat and he has no armor, he's very slow.
Okay, so you roll, you kill it.
I don't have the six.
Just raises her rapier and she just slams it through the thing's heart if he has one. She just pulls out her rapier and she licks it.
Oh, disgusting!
Critical hit, I don't think I can do that.
He just falls back and green blood starts spurting out
his
heart.
Nice.
What do you want to do? It's all clear for the moment.
Maybe we should
take a long rest.
No.
Yeah.
You've only got one spell used, right?
Yeah,
you only use one spell as well.
Yeah.
Oh god, okay. Could we...
I didn't get hit.
Yeah, I didn't get hit either.
Yeah, thanks guys. I didn't get hit either.
Take it like a man.
She says this with like blood smeared over her face.
Like in calm with her heart face. There's like a little bit of blood
like
splitting
out. Yeah, I didn't get hurt either.
No hurt.
Okay, so what shall we do?
Heal me.
Could you, I don't know, do you have enough cure wound slots?
Yeah, I can do 3 more, but
I'd rather save it.
I'm okay.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just crawling on the floor, but it'll be fine.
It'll be fine.
Yeah.
It's just
a I want to go down and check if the barmaid is still there. Like, did these things come from the people?
Okay.
So we out the window or down the stairs?
Down the stairs. Right. Okay. Keeping an ear out for anything.
Let's check the last one, the guy.
Yeah.
No, you stand in between the two of us. Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, we...
We check.
I'm at the back, you're at the front, you're in the middle.
Yeah.
And we head
to... So she's got some protection.
Yeah.
We head to the
to the room where Steve saw the guy.
Yeah.
Guys, take a left! Okay, so you guys are heading to the room with the guy. How? The passage is 5 foot wide, so how are you guys walking there?
I'm in front, in the center, the two of them are like split. So if it's.
No, you can't really split because it's only 5 foot wide.
Okay.
Yeah. So you have to walk in a single file.
Okay, yeah, I'm in front, Pink's in the middle, Steve's in the back.
Yeah. Okay, keeping an eye out.
Okay, you
run off. Keeping your eyes and ears and, like, I don't know, noses out.
Yeah, okay, you burst out of the room, you.
Going
run,
quickly
yeah,
and slowly.
Run in the corridor slowly.
Yeah,
you slowly walk towards the room where the guy is.
Keeping an ear out.
Steve, can you make a perception roll?
Oh shit.
11,
something's gonna happen.
12.
Yeah, you hear sounds coming from your room. Some things have just burst into your room.
Oh.
And
did we pull the door shut on our way out?
Can we assume we did?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Cover your belongings and you shut the door before you left.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay.
Okay, you advance towards the guy's room. You are now in front of the guy's room, it's closed.
Okay.
What do you want to do?
I want to push it open slowly.
Okay, you push it open. You push it open and you feel it stop.
Is there anything we can see?
Not really. You seem to have hit something.
Guys, I think there's something behind the door.
Just whack it.
No,
fine.
I slam the door open.
Okay. Slam the door open. Okay, Steve, at this point in time, you see your room, you're taking a back and you see the room, your room's door just open.
Yeah.
And one of those fat humanoids start advancing.
Oh jeez.
Is it the one which we put down before? Do I recognize it?
It's probably a new one. You can't really recognize it, but you assume there's a new one.
But it's not missing part of its head.
It's not missing part of its head, yeah.
Okay.
It's not bleeding anyway.
Oh jeez.
Alright, so we got a new one. And I go, guys, there's a new one.
Yeah, somebody's got it.
Oh, great. In which case, I know that they're going to attack me. I've done it to a fireball because they're resistant to that. Chromatic Orb again. With acid. 17.
Alright, you master up your acidic orb and you fling it towards the creature. You connect.
3d8. Oh! 8.
8.
That's horrible.
I don't trust the green dice, honestly. The green dice have been rolling shit for me, so.
Your orb slams into the creature, like, there's a burst of acid and it starts dissolving him, but he's still standing. He's like,
is he the only one?
Huh? He apparently is the only one.
Okay.
From what you can see. Pink, your turn.
Hand crossbow.
Okay. Pink just coolly pulls out a hand crossbow.
Yeah, you just like that, like the side there, like that.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, you don't have to duck around Steve.
That's right. Oh god, yeah.
You put it on my head like a tripod.
Yeah, you rest it on Steve's head.
Yeah. Sniping it.
Does she get advantage for that?
No. She's like a little Scorpius, little weaver.
Headshot! Fine.
No, as in you roll to attack us using.
Attack.
Yeah, sorry.
My bad.
Okay, this is Kim's first time playing game.
Yeah. It's cool, she get used to it.
14
plus.
Right, plus?
5 or 6, no, 4. 4.
Isn't it?
Plus
4.
Plus 4.
So it's 18, you managed to hit, so how much? You don't need to roll for damage.
Cool.
Your boat connects, flies straight into the thing's skull and it just gets flung backwards as it dies.
All those games have been helping you guys.
I don't think Pink played those video games. Yeah.
Alright, so at this moment, you try and slam the door. It slams against whatever's behind it and you see it just open. And one of those green apes with a pig's face.
Okay. I think those are people. I think Mike killed the barmaid.
Never mind.
I don't really care, it's gonna kill us.
Oh,
alright.
He was standing behind the door all this while, and he starts to. And he brings his fangs down on you as he tries to bite you, but he misses, and it follows up with a claw.
Does it hit?
That will not hit. You manage to. How high is it, is it?
13.
Yeah. With your uncanny senses, you manage to step back and see the claw just go in front of your face.
Yeah. I do rage push-ups.
And as it does that, you see this. you hear as this green cloud starts emanating from
Did it fart?
Yeah, this creature.
Wow!
It flows out of the room enveloped in blue and pink. So the poor girl enveloped by this green gas.
Oh no.
Wow.
You must.
Oh jeez, okay.
Later okay. I'll tell you what happens. Okay, so it's your turn. You must make a constitution saving throw.
Okay, constitution saving throw?
Yep.
Do I have advantage on that? No, 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 that's a strength check. Okay. 10 plus 2 plus 2, 14.
Alright, you survived this.
What's it, poison gas or something?
There's some kind of gas emanating from you. You breathe in, it feels disgusting. Something tries to weaken you, but you manage to shake it off.
Okay. Okay. Ugh, disgusting. I'm just gonna wait and then whack at it.
Okay, you bring your axe to bear.
I'm gonna use the green dice. 11 plus 4?
15, yeah, you manage to.
Blood.
You feel that his skin is really tough, but you manage to cleave through it and into, into his flesh.
Alright, alright, alright. D10.
Are you still raging though, right?
No, no, okay, I am. It lasts for 1 minute. Did it take us 1 minute to get?
Yeah,
okay, fine.
Sure
fine.
raging through the corridor.
Yeah, okay. I do 3 damage to it.
Okay, you cleave into it, you do 3 damage to it. Nice.
Really? No.
Yeah, you scratch it.
Yeah.
Steve's turn.
Sorry, this is a bit of a question. Is prestidigitation powerful enough to blow away the gas? Because I can't make a puff of wind.
No.
No.
Okay, in which case.
Yes, yeah.
I can create a little cloud. Yeah, okay, I won't do that then.
You notice that the cloud is obscuring the vision of pink was behind you. You turn around, pink's no longer there, it's just a green cloud.
Ah, okay, so I can't see the monster.
No, just take down. Oh, it's dead, right?
Yeah, the one behind me is dead.
Oh, sorry, yeah. 3 more of those things.
Oh, wow, sorry, yeah, wow.
All 3 are clustered together?
Yeah, from where the room was, I forgot about that, yeah.
Wow.
But they didn't reach you in time. They are really slow, so they are lumbering towards you.
In which case, I cast a snowball in amongst them.
Okay.
Snowball.
Yeah.
It is Snarlock Snowball Swarm.
So this little smiling robot just flies around.
Don't you? Don't
you? And then it starts swirling and ice covers the area.
10.
You rolled a 10.
I rolled. That's
no, wait,
It's a dexterity saving throw.
Right, so the three of them have to make a dexterity saving throw.
So my spell DC is 13.
Okay, two of them will succeed, one of them fails,
mm-hmm.
The one in front fails.
3d6.
Oh, jeez, that's really terrible.
It does cold damage, right?
Yeah.
5. Yes, it does cold damage. 5 for the people listening.
Right, you see the frost starts to form among them, but part of it just falls off as if spell is not very effective.
I think they're just resistant to magic.
No, no, because
acid worked, right?
Yeah, and behind, even though they are like fat and bulbous, they manage to somehow like weave their way through your snowball swarm and not get hit so badly.
Right.
And you barely manage to scratch them.
Okay.
Okay.
Bing.
Can I see these 3 people? You're in the cloud, right?
Yeah. No, no, 3 of them are behind.
Oh, okay.
Steve is coming out from your room.
Okay.
You can see the 3 of them. But you can barely see them through the cloud.
Sleep? So they get. Again? What the hell? You get to sleep. Okay, I'm gonna do Thunder Wave.
Thunder Wave.
Wait, you will hit both me and Steve.
So
how come
Steve,
you guys are standing in front of me? Yeah, I'm in front of you and Steve is behind me.
So you are standing in the middle of
Pink. Yeah, this is where you are. This is me, this is the monster, this is Steve.
Yeah.
3 monsters.
So I'm doing it in Steve's direction.
So Thunder Wave
like,
fuck.
Yeah.
Okay.
Shit. Okay. Yeah, I guess sleep is the only option. Right.
That is our
God end. God damn it!
Sleep it is! 5d8!
Alright!
Okay.
Alright, thank you. D8.
And
void. That's enough?
No, no.
Five. Oh god.
Just throw them all out. Just drop them. Roll this one.
Oh, hey.
17, 20. 17. Sorry, can you
move
your hand?
6, 6, 5,
7, 4. Yeah,
28. Yeah, okay. Does it do?
Yeah, you put the. Sorry, grab the wrong one. Oh, the one that Steve injured. Oh, it's dead. Okay, sorry. Yeah. Yeah, you put the three of them to sleep. The three of them just deflate a little and they sleep.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, the dude behind you.
The dude is still standing.
Yep.
Yeah, he's not within your area.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, it's their turn, the dude.
Fight me, bro. Fight me.
Yeah. Carries on humbling. Oh, sorry, during your turn, can you make a constitution saving throw?
Oh, because you're in the gas. Should you move out of the gas thing after? Can we move out of the gas?
Yes, you can, but you have to step past Steve.
Should you step over his head? He's very short. Oh my god! One. That's a one, guys.
You're breathing. Breathing the gas, you start coughing, you feel it weaken you, you now suffer disadvantage on all your attacks and ability checks.
Melee attacks or magic as well?
Attack rolls, yeah. If it's a magic attack.
Okay, okay. Okay. Got it.
Yeah, you're only poisoned until the next turn. Alright, the being behind the door starts. She just tears the door open and then starts pummeling at you.
Good god.
It brings both his fists down to bear on you, and one of them will connect.
I'll take it.
And you take 5 points of damage.
That's fine.
Okay.
Pshaw.
Say this. It's not super strong.
Okay.
Because then.
Yeah, I'm just light.
Yeah, okay. Raise your axe.
Okay, don't fail me. 10 plus 5. Plus 4.
Plus 4.
Oh, can
alright.
Should I reach now? No, I'm not gonna bother reaching.
Yeah, you cleave your axe into the thing's stomach. How much damage do you do?
1d10. 7 plus 2. 9.
Okay, you cleave the thing in the stomach and it starts to bleed, but it's still standing.
Jeez.
Okay, Steve's turn.
Alright, so there's only one which is awake. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna firebolt at him.
Does he look damaged?
Yeah, he's pretty damaged.
And this is not the fire resistant guy, this is the gorilla pig, right? The pig gorilla.
Yeah, yeah.
So we don't know if he's resistant to fire.
Yeah, don't know.
It's like being
excuse me, sorry.
So you don't have direct line of sight to him. You want to step up to where Pickle is?
I don't want to walk into the cloud. I'm wondering. So either way, like, can I shuffle around in this hallway until I can see him and cast my fireball?
He's obscured by the cloud.
So either way, I'm just gonna have disadvantage on the
roll. Yeah, you will. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I don't really have any choice. I'm not gonna go into the cloud. Okay. So that was 14, and that one was 10.
Okay. The 10 is not good enough. You fire blinding into the cloud and you hear your fireball miss.
Does the gas catch on fire?
Nope.
Okay.
I don't think we want the gas to catch on fire, seeing as we are in it.
You're pretty short. It might be above your head.
Pink, your turn.
Pink. Am I still at disadvantage?
Constitution saving throw.
Balls! Okay. Come on.
You do it. 20. 20.
Wait, no. I did that one. Come on.
Wait, what?
Because.
Let me
roll.
Hi.
10. Oh my god. 10
plus constitution. 2.
Okay, you managed to resist the effects of the poison.
Just like,
okay. Oh god, okay. Okay, I'm gonna give each of them, but...
No, you can't. You can only do one at a time, I think.
Wait, oh, really?
Only one.
Okay, who's up to me?
The monster.
Just to me. Pickle.
Pickle is up to you.
Okay, so I'll give you Bardic Inspiration.
Okay.
Okay. And,
But I can't use it for attack rolls, though, so, like, you should probably give Steve.
Okay.
Yes, you can use it for attack rolls.
No, I think I can't use it to do damage, what?
Yes, you can, she's from the school of valor.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Super cool.
Yeah. So,
you hear Pink whisper and you're inspired.
Yeah.
Be inspired. And she's suddenly inspired.
Just do it.
I can do something else too, right?
That's your bonus action to inspire. You have the three sleeping guys away in the distance, you have the monster.
Let's crossbow the monster.
Which one, the sleeping one or the one that Pickle is fighting?
The one Pickle's fighting.
Okay, so he's slightly obscured by both the gas and the corner of the door. So it's a bit hard to hit. Okay. So can you attack with disadvantage?
Can she just rest the crossbow bolt on my head and then shoot from there since I'm right
in
front of
her? Yeah, but he's still obscured by the car.
18?
No, this is roll again. You'll take the lower number.
Oh, come on!
20!
Oh, freaking hell!
Yeah, you miss. Your bolt does go throng on the corner of the door.
Like 2 inches above my head.
Yeah.
Alright.
Alright, the monster continues pummeling at you. The rest of the guys are still sleeping.
Love that sleep
spell. Yeah, good work. Your AC is not very high.
13,
so. Yeah, both his attacks will hit.
Oh, okay.
He brings his fist down on you, and he bites you, and you take a total of 9 points of damage.
Oh my god.
So you feel his fist and his bite.
Wait, what's 25 minus 16, right?
Against you, yeah.
Okay.
Make a constitution saving throw.
14 plus.
Yeah, okay, cool.
4.
You resist it.
Okay, attack.
Yeah.
13 plus 4?
Yeah, you managed to hit it. So what are you going to do?
Whack it. Oh, 2 plus 2.
Okay, you do 4 grand points of damage. it's barely standing, but you managed to cleave another chunk out of its arm this time.
I wish I was raging.
Like dangling.
Maybe I should have raged. Oh.
Steve's done.
I'm still going to attack with disadvantage. I don't really want to walk into the cloud.
Wait, can I use my bonus inspiration to my attack? To do damage?
You can, yeah.
So 1d6, right?
D6.
Okay. Oh my god!
It's still standing.
That was a 1, folks.
You rolled a 1.
Shitty. 1.
Okay, so I'm going to still attack with disadvantage. Same story, firebolt. I assume the cloud hasn't dissipated by now.
As long as the creature is standing, there will be a cloud.
Ah, okay, good to know. That's disadvantage, natural 1. I got 6 on that.
Your firebolt is almost...
Yeah.
No.
Pinkston, constitution save.
He's like...
Oh wait, I get to reroll with 1s.
Oh yeah.
Excellent, because I'm lucky.
If you luck change.
14, I roll again.
Disadvantage.
And 6, 11.
No, because there's a corner of the doorpost, so you hit the doorpost.
His AC goes up a bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, can I go nearer towards the door?
Yeah, you can, by making a constitution save first, right. Because you're in a cloud.
That's right.
You can do it.
Holy shit.
11.
Yep,
plus
2.
Oh, okay.
Resist the cloud.
Okay. So I move nearer and...
Okay, you push past people and you come face to face with the monster.
Can she just whack on top of me?
Whatever.
Okay, yeah.
Well, I can't face to face with him. Okay, can I...
Close enough to smooch him.
Whoa. No! I'm not this scared of shit. We're gonna just hit his face. Alright? Okay.
Why not? He looks like this.
Yeah, Gabe. Yeah, go for it, Gabe. Seriously, what do you want?
Pink's type.
It looks like if I smooch him, I would die. Okay?
Yeah, you'll die from depression.
No, you would just be like, this kiss,
whatever. Look at his mouth area! Oh my god,
freak! Like, you kiss him and you're like, I'm never gonna get a better kiss than this, and you die.
Why?
Okay, guys.
Is like kissing a kiss?
I love this conversation going on during the battle.
Yeah,
you kiss him.
It's like kissing a wild boar that has died and is rotting for the.
Yeah,
exactly.
Wow.
Pink
time. Really? Very attractive
and
proposition.
Like
okay, I'm gonna hit his face, okay?
Okay, hit his face.
But because of okay, it says here that I have Savage Attack, which is a bonus critical dice with melee.
No.
Ooh.
Only when you crit then you get to roll extra dice.
Oh damn, okay. Well, okay. So here we go.
Here we go.
That's a 4. Eight.
It's okay, you get disadvantage. You get in the cloud. You try to hit its face, but you hit the door instead.
Okay.
Yeah, this door,
is taking damage.
The door is the biggest enemy in this
room. The door is like, has taken so much abuse.
Is the door on fire from my firewall?
No.
It's just charred and smoking a little bit.
It's just angry.
It's an angry door.
Okay, it's turn. He brings his fist down on two of you, so each of you gets one. Both of his attacks will miss.
Oh.
He swings through the cloud and can't see either.
Oh my god, this is stupid.
Pickle's turn.
I'm just gonna like, buddy, this has gone way too long.
That's your con save, you failed.
Yeah.
Now poison.
That's great.
Okay, so your attack roll now has
disadvantage.
You have disadvantage anyway, because you're obscured.
Five.
5
plus
4, 9. Yeah, you swing in the
Oh
the
my
mist.
God, this is getting ridiculous.
You see the mist just
Can I just
a little bit.
Shove past him a little bit so that maybe if the gas ends where he is, I can...
Okay, you shove past him and you are now inside the room.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
But is he still in the cloud? Like, is he the center of the cloud?
No.
Okay.
No, actually, yeah, you are still in the cloud. The cloud emanates from him for like 10 feet.
Sorry, that was my fault. I was just curious to know how it worked.
You're pushing the room in and still in the cloud.
Ugh,
like,
okay.
Shit.
But he's still like half behind the door.
Yeah.
And I'm still outside
the
cloud.
Yeah, you definitely have part time thing, but there are three sleeping guys who seem to be stirring.
Oh, they do.
They'll
wake
up?
Yeah, they will wake up like 1 hour.
No, 1 hour, yeah.
Right, yeah, they're not stirring, they're not snoring.
No,
okay.
Man. I thought it was a minute.
It's 1 minute. Oh, it's 1 minute.
Ooh, so it's a minute, in which case.
Okay.
I'm gonna walk over to close to one of these guys. Not so close that if they wake up, they're gonna straight away attack me.
Yeah.
So out of their reach, they're close enough. And. Well, the sleeping guys are all the pig men, aren't they?
Yeah.
Okay. So
they're not big men, they're like the fat
ones. Oh, the fat ones. So I have got a couple more chromatic orbs up my sleeve, so I might as well do that. So yeah, chromatic orb, acid. So I'll do that for the one which is closest.
Okay. The closest one is slightly more hurt than the rest, just very slightly.
Oh, great.
Here's like an extra scratch.
Okay. 17, 20.
Right.
22.
You hit this sleeping target.
3D8.
So you get a crit. But I don't think you need a crit. Why don't you roll 3D8 first?
Okay. Where's the other D8? That one? Oh, I shouldn't be rolling the green, as you say.
Yeah, see, the green rolls terrible.
14. Yeah, 14. You fire a chromatic orb and it just kills the sleeping guy.
Yeah,
it just
absorbs
the
pulp
and acidic goo.
Awesome. One down.
Okay.
Kingston. Yeah, don't need to make constitution saves because you're in the cloud anyway, you can't see shit.
Yeah. Okay, wow. Just whack him and then we can get onto
the... Am I near enough? Far? Near enough to whack
him? Yeah, we're face to face with him.
Oh, wait, that dude. Okay,
yeah
just whack him.
Whack
with
him.
The,
whack him.
Whack him.
Whack him.
Come on.
Whack him, smack him.
Oh my good god.
Yeah, disadvantage, so that would be the one.
Yeah.
That was a two.
Yeah. You swing your rig and you go smack against the guy, but he didn't swing it.
No, it smacked against the door, the door.
the door.
How much damage is
the
door?
Like, come on, guys! Cut it off!
What did I do?
Yeah, the guy just tries to claw you and takes a bite out of pink.
Dude, wow, he's like multitasking,
yeah,
man.
And he bites you.
Oh, no.
And he manages to land a kiss. Yeah, you take 4 points of damage as you feel his teeth just rip across your arm.
Bastard, don't kiss me.
And at this point in time, you see one more of the green apes lumber up the steps.
And
he looks
the
around,
entire town.
He looks at you, he looks at the sleeping guy.
He smacks
the sleeping guy.
There's mother. Oh no, okay.
So one of them has woken up.
Okay.
Okay, Pickle's turn.
Just whack the guy in front of me again.
Okay.
13 plus 4, please say that hits.
A disadvantage. Because it's a cloud.
12.
Yeah, okay, you hit. Yeah,
okay.
That's fine. Yeah, you hit. You managed to see its movement in the cloud and you predict.
Okay, so the cloud's gone. Okay, I'm gonna.
Yeah.
With my movement, can I move to stand in front of Steve and Pink? So they'll attack me first.
Pink is in the room. So Pink is safe. So you step in front of Steve.
Yeah.
You see this this halfling, so I said, this gnome just jump over your head and then land in front of you.
Yeah, like,
huh! Hey! She's going like, ah! I'm like, Pickle!
And I would like to go into a rage.
Yeah, okay. So she goes like, ah! Looking forward like a red Indian.
Alright.
Tomahawk in hand.
I'm pretty sure I can shoot past you because you're little.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just like,
Yeah, sure.
Okay, cool, thank you. So we've got one of the zombies and one of the pigmen. And the pigman's smarter and he might wake up the zombie.
One sleeping and one not sleeping.
Yeah, but he might wake up the second troll, so I'm going to go for the pigman. And I'm going to go with my last chromatic orb.
No, save your chromatic orbs for the zombie dudes. Pigman's weak
to fire. Oh, yeah, correct. Yeah, sorry. Well, no, we don't know if pigman's weak to fire.
Oh, what if they take fire damage?
Now's the time to try.
Yeah. I'm going for fireball.
Okay.
22.
22?
Yeah.
The clouds are gone with you, right?
Yeah, the clouds are gone.
Yeah, so I assume that hits, right?
Yep, that hits.
So 1d10.
Roll high.
4.
Damn.
That's it.
Okay. You fling your arm and a bolt of fire erupts, it connects with the pigman, but part of it just dissipates. Against its height. Yeah, it doesn't take the full brunt of your.
So fire's just not very good here. Yeah. Alright, gotta use up a.
No, that was a firebolt.
So. Demons, guys.
I don't get it. What demons?
They're all immune to fire, apparently.
They're not immune, but they take.
They're just resistant to fire.
Damage. Yeah. Ping's done.
But it took.
Ping, you're in the room. The cloud disappears and the guy just collapses in front of you. Pom.
Give him one last kiss and then like.
Oh wow, he's already like.
Yeah, but there's three more enemies.
Yeah, you hear fighting outside the room.
Okay.
So you can either investigate the room or.
So wait, but the pig guy, there's one more pig guy outside at the corridor.
Pig guy, there's a pig guy in the corridor.
Yeah.
With two more others.
One sleeping slime and one not sleeping slime.
Take out the gorilla because he just woke up one of the trolls and he'll probably wake up the second troll.
Okay. Shit.
Or we can clean up the room.
For what?
He's being a dumb.
He's being a troll.
Okay, the problem about this is that I see this never ending.
They just keep coming?
Yeah. So
call us into the room and shut the door again?
Clear these three and then move somewhere else.
Can we just
run?
Run out the window.
They're blocking the staircase and we're on the second floor.
No, I mean, wait, go back to the room. I'm sure there's a window we can jump out.
We could try.
Okay. I'm going for whatever.
I'm worried that if they come running after us, they'll sound the alarm. Whereas if we kill them and we move on, they won't know where to find us. You know what I mean?
No.
Like how, okay, say in Ghost Recon, you alert someone. If you don't kill them before you move on, they will run after you while you run.
But
and keep alerting people, right? Whereas if you kill them, then move on, there's no alarm and you can. And even though people will come in this general direction, they will know exactly where you've gone.
Hmm. Yeah, I guess. Okay.
Clean up these three and then reach out.
Okay, then. So, I go up there and I'll probably do a hand crossbow.
Do you have any attacks? Magical?
No, just
climb away. Okay. Nah, just whack him then.
Whack him? From afar?
Yeah.
Okay, hand crossbow.
Which one? The
pig guy.
Yeah. Okay, the gorilla. The green gorilla with the pig face.
15 plus 4, 19.
Okay. You step out of the room and you fire over Pickle and Steve's head.
With no cloud, you can
hit. The you see like this bolt just fly across the top of the head.
Yeah.
And it lands on the guy. And how much damage do you do? 3 plus?
2, so 5.
Yeah, bolt goes thrung on the guy's arm. He moves back a little from the impact of the blow, but he's still standing.
Okay,
so now three of you are outside the room. She's in front of the second and she's the last.
Yeah.
So the gorilla dude just shoves the barbarous human behind him, like sort of instructing him to wake up the one behind. He advances towards the three of you against towards Pickle. And he jumps up and then he slams his fist down upon you.
So I'll take half damage.
Of course you are
raging.
Right, you take two points of damage total. Yeah.
Total?
Yeah,
is it before half or after half?
After half.
Okay.
Yeah, you raise your axe to block his blow, but you feel the impact nevertheless.
Okay.
The other guy will wake up the last one, and yeah, that's all. And start moving 14. Towards you.
14. Okay, I'm gonna whack the guy in front of me first.
Okay.
I'm not gonna use this die. 3 plus 4.
And you swing your axe up, but the guy calmly just deflects it with his arm. As if he's trained for combat. Steve's turn.
Do I know from before when I was checking them out, do I know anything about their history? Like, are they weak to light, for example?
Not really.
Okay, just checking. In which case, firebolt's useless. I'm running out of spells,
sunlight.
Guys, but I got no choice.
Yeah, just use firebolt and it does some damage.
It does, and we don't know if we're going to encounter worse people later.
So save your
Portal staff?
Yeah, I poke it with my stick. No, I do not. I throw it because that would be worse. I
throw your portal staff.
Dunk! And it just falls. I cast firebolt at the weakest one.
Whoever looks the weakest.
They will get cover because they are behind this hulking dude.
Then just get the hulking dude.
Fine, I'll just go to the
fighting pickle.
Yeah.
Fine, I'll go
locked in life and death content.
18.
Yep, you hit. You unleash a fearsome bolt of fire.
1d10. There it is.
And you do.
I think that's 10. It was on the cast
for
10 and 9.
You unleash a bolt of fire and erupts on him, but thanks to his fire resistance, he doesn't take that much damage. And it's Pink's turn.
What?
We are standing at the back. You see your two friends in front of you, and you see Pickle fighting this gorilla. It's not really a gorilla, it's just like.
Okay. This is some weird monkey thing.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, I'll just whack him. Whack him with a. I'm still quite far away, unless I should cast.
Okay, can she reach him over our heads?
Sure.
Rapier, then there we go.
Oh, we want to use a melee attack.
So
I'm
too far.
You can pull Pickle away from him so that you become the front.
No.
But you can't squeeze with Pickle.
Yeah,
okay, then I'll take the hand crossbow thing.
Because there are slaying demons with a crossbow!
6 plus 4.
10.
9.
You take aim, you fire, your crossbow goes thunk off the guy's skin.
Oh jeez.
And
that
it's his turn.
Again.
He starts looking angry and he starts clawing and biting at you.
Oh god.
And wow.
Oh no. That is not a sound.
Yeah. You dodge his claw, but his bite comes down and it connects and you take a. 6 points of damage after reducing 3. You take 3 points of damage.
Okay.
As you feel his bite claw in your skin.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna whack him back.
Okay.
I'll give the green die a chance. Nope! Out! Never mind. No more.
So he bites you and he tries to give you a punch, but he manages to pull out.
Stupid green dice.
Pulling some of the flesh with him. Steve.
Alright. Same deal. I keep wailing on the.
It's like those RPG majors where you just right click die.
Yeah, right click.
He's just casting firebolt.
Yeah, firebolt, same deal. 21. Presumably that hits. 1 damage. I read that as like, yes, a 10!
No.
Oh, it's a 1.
So does it go down to 0?
And what do you pay?
Yeah, I think so. I think it goes down to 0.
Oh jeez.
So
resistance.
Oh, resistance goes to 0.
He just gets like no damage.
It's how it
sure.
Helps
I need to
it.
Clarify the rules later.
If it helps it
Kingston.
Then, yeah.
Doesn't round up.
No.
How many of them are there?
3. Don't sleep again.
Nah.
Sleep?
Nah, just whack him.
Signature spell.
Okay, just want a health check. That's 11.
I haven't been hit, so
okay.
I'm still on 9.
Right, let's change
yeah.
that.
Don't worry.
What?
Okay, hand crossbow.
Six ninjas appear with long bones. It almost like firing at
9 plus 4. 13.
Alright, you hit. You see the hulking figure. You take another aim using Pickle's head as a tripod.
Yeah, do it.
3
plus
5. Okay, your foot slams into the guy's head and he just falls backwards. Boom.
Finally! Okay, now it's just left the two dudes, right?
Yeah, the two dudes behind, they start lumbering towards you. So, because it's a narrow passage, only one of them can hit you. They swing their claws at you, both of them hit.
Oh!
Take it!
How are you doing? Are you, are 11. You on 11?
I'm still in two digits, but not for long.
Having said that, how many hits have you taken?
A lot.
I'm so glad you're in front of me.
Yep.
Good work stepping in.
2, 6. So you take 4 points of damage total after reduction. And feel its claws grabbing you. Pickle, your turn.
7, right?
11
or
yeah,
6?
Yes, it's 7.
Yeah, I'm just gonna wipe the one in front of me. Not
green,
using the
green one. Next up.
Yep.
Slam it down.
Seriously?
That face. You might manage to hit it. How much is that for?
3 plus 4.
I know. Yeah. Oh. You miss this large and slow target.
Somehow.
Like it's not on your side.
I still reckon it's worth just launching fireballs. I can't think of anything better to do with that, given the situation.
Chuck does it.
Yeah, no.
They're not human, right?
Try and have a conversation with him. Natural 1. I get to roll again. 17.
What if you roll 1 20, and the 1 again?
22.
The miss is really unlucky.
Yeah, 22.
22? Okay, you hit.
D10. 7.
7.
Yeah, your bolt of fire lands on the thing's face. Part of it is melted off, but you resist your firebolt as usual. Pink
shirt. Do they look hurt?
Yeah, they look quite hurt.
Okay, shoot him.
Can I heal you first? I'm gonna heal you first. Also, if I take another
okay,
one.
Okay, thank you.
So when you were in the room, you noticed that the guy is no longer there. There's no cops or anything.
He turned into the monster thing. I'm pretty sure he turned into the monkey thing.
And we just killed him.
Yep.
What monkey thing?
Imagine the monkey thing doing this.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, I've seen those monkey things. They've got symbols.
Okay.
Okay,
whack him.
D20.
No, I'm
carrying
you.
Oh,
man.
Okay, thanks.
Alright.
Let's just call them bigger demons and smaller demons.
Thank you.
Three.
There are two small
plus
demons.
Two. 5.
Oh, you managed to hit?
No. Healing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So, a glow of light. As you're fighting, you feel like this friendly hand on your shoulder and you feel your wounds close. And the little demon starts grabbing at you again with his claw. Oh, I'm rolling them well for them.
I might borrow back the pink dice for a while.
You take 3 points of damage total after resistance. You feel scrabbled by your rage, you shake off most of the pain.
I'm gonna whack it.
And the thing behind it is just like standing there waiting for his body to die. It's just patiently waiting until it can attack.
Seriously? Oh, that's a 2. Why am I... I'm cursed.
Like,
cursed, you guys.
Your head slips and you're your ex. Flies out and lands on the wall, and you have to pull it up. Steve's turn.
Alright, same deal. We all know what Steve's gonna do. Natural 20.
Rotating D10.
Oh, 2D10.
Yeah.
That's what it means.
Critical. You feel an unnaturally large bolt of fire erupt from your hand.
8.
And you 4 points of damage and you melt the thing's face off.
Hey!
Pink, your turn. Now there's space between Pickle and the guy. You can stand in front of Pickle if you want or not.
Nah. No, I'm still raging.
Man, not at this thing. Hand crossbow, man.
Hand crossbow, you continue wheeling away at the guy.
Just like Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
19.
Just like this flurry of arrows, reload fire, reload fire. Time crisis.
Quiet.
4. Plus 2. 6.
Pretty good.
Man, I'm gonna buy my own set of dice.
Yeah, the bolt just launches into the thing, and the thing moves forward and starts to attack you with its claws, and it misses all the way.
Okay.
You manage to step out of the way this time. You have learned its attack patterns.
I want to use this die. 10 plus 4.
Okay, you hit. Cleave your axe and shoot you dead unless you look like shit. Right.
No,
that's fine.
You're
still dead.
No, wait, let me...
It dies.
Oh, 6, okay.
It cleaves you in half, and then this green blood just spurts out in your face.
Okay, let's move, you guys. Let's move.
Where do you want to move?
Wait. Okay, so I'm okay health-wise. You're...
I'm 8.
You're mediocre.
I'm 7.
We are not in a good situation, so we're stuck in this place.
Yeah, but they know to come look for us here. So climb up the fucking...
Before we duck out, is there anything in any of the rooms? Like the rooms, not without investigating like all the places,
but
just in the spots we can see.
So you take the next hour?
Yeah.
No.
Just look at the room. Does anything look different?
Like the room we were in before, and like the corridor. Is there anything which has changed?
No.
Okay, is there anything on the bodies? Like that's worth grabbing?
Just flesh.
Okay.
No money.
No money.
Over. Wipe your shoes so we don't track blood all over, and then let's move.
Prestidigitation.
Yeah. Okay.
So.
Okay. Let's. Can we look down the stairs to see the barmaids downstairs?
Yeah. You go downstairs. The barmaids no longer
okay,
there.
Okay. Let's.
Duck out of town.
Is there a back door to the inn?
No. There is a front door and there are windows.
The kitchen has no door outside?
No.
So we know that the fountain is.
It's probably
the
source
door.
Of. Yeah.
Is probably.
Can you stare out the windows? See the fountain?
I just realized that we're probably fainting from thirst. Do we need to do anything?
Okay, if you look up the window.
You have to look at the fountain.
Yeah, from the room opposite your room, you look out the window and see that the fountain is still there. It's no longer the nice angelic statue anymore. The angel has been broken in half, so only the lower torso is there.
Oh, yeah, wait. Say that again.
The top half has disappeared.
So now it's about midnight, right?
Yeah, now it's about midnight. Oh. Yeah, and above.
Taking a long time.
Above its legs, where its body used to be, where its upper body used to be, there is this. Green oval disc shimmering above it, something like a portal of sorts.
Ooh.
Should we jump through that?
That's what I'm thinking. I'm keen to get jumped through a portal.
Surrounding the fountain, there are a few of these things. You can pick up like four of the bulbous, four of the smaller demons and two of the bigger ones. Just lumbering around.
Just not headed in our direction, just lumbering around.
Not headed in our direction, yeah.
Oh, so the podium had a symbol on it, a night and a day.
Yeah,
thing.
I'm thinking it's
so like,
it,
sometimes
yeah.
it's good, sometimes it's bad,
yeah.
maybe. And also maybe sometimes the portal's open, sometimes it's not.
I don't think it's a portal. Does it look like a portal?
Yes, it looks like a green version of the red one, is that true?
Red. Red brought us to the red sky place, green takes us to a green sky place.
Wanna just run through and leap through the portal?
Acidic pool.
I am not happy about the number of spells I've got left. So I'm becoming more and more useless to you guys. I don't know what our options are there.
Okay, wait, should we take a break first? It's 1.5 hour mark.
Yeah, alright, let's take a short break
to pee and answer questions.
Respond to everyone talking in the chat.
Okay.
Sure.
I need to use the washroom.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, so do we have a break screen?
We do?
Yeah. Do you guys want to start answering questions first?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Alright, we're back. Okay, we are back. The party has disposed of some demons in the inn, so they realize that at night these townsfolk, happy townsfolk, turn into demons.
Okay.
Freaking knew it!
Yep.
And
it's pretty clear.
You see your way out of this hellish place in the middle of the town square.
Okay.
On top of the fountain.
It's midnight now, right?
It's midnight, yeah.
And there's guards between us and
not
the
guards,
yeah.
They're just wandering around
the
area.
Yeah, they're wandering around the area.
Okay. So I'm gonna try and sneak as we go.
Yeah, I wonder if we should just run through.
So our options as we're walking towards this, right? Slowly? And are we chatting on the way?
I'm wondering what's the difference, like the villagers turn to these things and like who turns into the monkey dude and who turns into a slime dude? You know? Like,
I know what you're saying. There's high level and lower level, some of them are stronger.
Yeah.
I don't know. The mayor is probably the big one and the innkeeper is probably a big one and then the townspeople are the little ones, I don't know.
I think the dude in the room must have been the monkey dude. Because when we opened the door, there was a monkey dude, right?
Yeah, true.
I think the barkeep might have been monkey dude. I just don't know where all the others are coming from.
Don't know. That doesn't matter.
Gabe.
How
high is this portal? Yeah, like, will it take a while to climb and everything?
It takes a little bit of effort, but it's not too bad.
We can't just jump.
It's on the statue in the middle of the fountain, so
okay,
you have to cross the fountain and climb a little bit of the ways up.
Should
we
take half an hour to short rest, get some hit dice, and then
half
make
an
a run?
Half an hour is not enough for a short rest.
It's not?
Okay,
hey,
guys, I have a plan, but I do not know if it will work.
Oh no,
okay.
Lay it on.
Who is the lighter one?
I'm lightest.
Yeah.
But you guys are really small, right?
We're both really small.
You're gonna grab us and run?
No, okay.
I'm gonna pull them.
No, I'm not. Is it possible for me
to throw me
to throw him into the bottle?
Yeah, sure. If we do that, we're splitting the party, and so if you guys get attacked, I'm not gonna be around to
No, we will make it in because I'm gonna cast invisibility on two of us.
But you are. Okay, so
we can only cast it on one person.
It's a concentration spell.
Yeah. You can't
Oh shit,
it
I can't draw.
Yeah, you can cast it once, that's all.
Yeah, you don't have it here, but it's a concentration spell.
Dude, that means I have got to toss both of you in.
And then you're on your own to fight. That's the risk.
Oh, I mean, wait, how many were there outside around the area?
There are about six of them.
Would her sleep spell cover all of them?
Not sure.
I think it's dangerous. Like, I love the idea. I think it's
just
so cool.
Yeah,
like,
I was just flinging us in.
I mean, I could go in V and just fling both of you guys in.
And then just hope that...
And then...
Okay, so... Well, let's see if you go invisible first, because there's some risk in
there. What's your strength? Their strength is 10. It's gonna be a... It's probably gonna be a strength check to fling us in. So...
One by one?
But how are you gonna, how are you gonna stay invisible when suddenly one of the dudes gets launched?
I know. Turn Steve invisible.
Uh-huh.
Have him go to the opposite end of the fountain. Like say, this is the fountain. This is the inn. This is the opposite end.
Yeah.
Have him go there while invisible. Create like sparks.
Yeah,
or
I
like,
can do that.
Like a thing. When they all go this side, we run in, and Steve is invisible, so he can.
Then I can do it because I can do minor illusion.
Okay.
But who's? I'm more sneaky.
Yeah, he's sneakier, so like when they're converging on him, he'll more likely be able to move around.
Then how is he gonna get around them?
I'll be invisible.
Yeah.
Because you cast invisibility.
Cast invisibility on him.
Oh.
Send him.
It doesn't break anything, right? The invisibility.
It doesn't. Does it?
I don't think so.
When you cast a spell, the invisibility breaks.
When he casts a spell?
Yeah.
So I can't do prestidigitation while
or
invisible.
Or like minor illusion.
Or minor illusion. I don't have minor illusion.
You'll break out invisibility.
That's why I have to use minor
illusion. Is not going to do it.
I'm gonna have to use minor illusion.
Like light a little candle.
How far is your minor illusion?
Try.
Okay.
30 feet.
And I'll tell you the result.
30 feet. How far is it from us to the fountain? From fountain to the other.
What do you wish to achieve?
We're wondering if she can minor illusion the opposite side of the fountain.
30 feet.
I've got 60 feet silent image. So I could cast some sort of distraction, like it looks like there's a fire or something, 60 feet away.
Just us, our faces there.
Or just our faces there.
Yeah.
I mean, it won't have any sound, so, but it's a 15, I think it's a 15 foot cube, so I could cast something on that side.
Yeah, we could let the two of us around there. Okay.
So
15 foot cube can easily form an image of the three of you standing around,
drinking
beer or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can we... Do you think it's worth, if I do this, if I cast an image of us...
60 feet is more than enough, right?
Okay. 60 feet is more than enough.
Okay.
So I've got a good range on this, but I really want to attract their attention and I can't do any sound.
I can. Minor illusion.
But minor illusion is the 30 feet.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Oh, so you do sound closer.
Yeah.
So 60 feet away is the
catch
image.
Catch their attention.
And the closer one is the sound.
And they'll head towards the image thinking is where the sound is from.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay, I'm thinking we should sneak out of this place. Like out of the back window, go around to the back and then make the minor illusion look like we're coming out from the door. They're more like to buy that we're coming out from the inn, right?
You're talking about concentration.
Yeah,
so I can do that, I can make it walk.
As in so if this is the fountain,
yep.
This is the inn.
Yep.
They're like scattered around here. Mm-hmm. We should move here. Use your illusion thingy to make it look like we're coming out from the inn.
Okay. So for everyone who's listening in, what Pickle just described is we put ourselves on the, like, with the fountain between us and the inn, but we make the image look like it's coming from the inn towards the fountain. Mm. So, did I describe that accurately?
Yeah. Does it make more sense?
Yeah, I think we should give it a crack.
Okay,
and
but we
are making the noise for it.
You'll be making noise as close as you can get with the 15 feet.
Yeah, like.
And, 30 feet.
As far as you can get from us, but as close as possible to the inn.
Okay.
And I'll just be conjuring the image of the three of us
like
walking.
Bloody and
bloody.
What's going on?
Yeah. While we sneak as far as we can around to the back.
Okay.
Alright, let's try.
Should we sneak some distance away first?
Before we cast it? Yeah. We sneak a little way away before we cast
it. You make a bloody stealth check, so three of you. You can make it with a bloody
advantage.
Okay.
Okay.
What is my green d20?
There we go, crit, so you succeed. So two of you will need to succeed.
Okay. 19.
Okay, that's good enough. That you need to roll really. The two of you managed to sneak around the back.
Yeah, boy.
Are you going to cast a silent image?
Yes.
Okay, so you clap your hands.
I yell my magic word.
Abracadabra.
Wingardium Leviosa. And this image appears on top of you.
Yeah, just walking around. It's doing a little dance.
Yeah.
No. I silently.
this image of the three of you all. Two of you are like bloodied and battered, and Steve is like unhurt.
I am literally unhurt.
Walking.
Yeah, coming out from
out
the
door. So I assume someone does a prestidigitation or whatever shit to open the door.
Yeah.
So the door swings open and the three of you walks out. Yeah. It catches the attention of all the demons and they start charging towards the door.
Okay, the moment there's like at least 10 feet between the demons and the fountain, we make a run for it.
Okay, but keeping concentration. I'm still keeping my sound image there.
So the three of you make a run towards the fountain with the cover of the night while the demons are distracted. You manage to reach the fountain.
Climb. I'm gonna get Pink and I. We're gonna hoist and fling him up because I don't think you brought athletics, right?
Okay, so the three of you are gonna help each other get up. So can the three of you make strength checks with advantage? And if the party succeeds, then three of you are safe. Safely make it to the bottom without any
strength checks, right?
Incidents. Yeah.
All friends.
Oh. Yeah, advantage.
Advantage? Yeah. Okay. Oh, thank God.
Because you're helping each other.
Oh, jeez.
Advantage. Oh, jeez. Oh my God, it's a 2! What do you mean? I rolled a 2 and a... Oh, you've already rolled?
Yeah. Just roll yours. Please be good. 15.
It makes a difference. I got a 4.
What's your highest?
I think it was like a 5.
Okay,
but plus your strength modifier, right?
Oh, plus... Wait, hold on.
Nah, that's not enough. Anyway, you...
Plus athletic strength?
Yeah, you
plus
managed
4?
To make it up the fountain, but you managed to cut and scrape yourselves.
Oh, jeez, okay.
Yeah, and injure yourselves in the process, so you take... Oh, you take 9 points of damage.
Oh!
Oh, shit!
Yeah,
I'm out! I'm unconscious.
Are you?
No, but she rolled a 15.
What?
She rolled a 15.
Oh, yeah, the party failed as a whole. Yeah. So, Pickle slips and trips.
Oh, jeez.
On the ledge.
We should have long rested.
You rolled out to 1, because you're off.
Alright,
Just
grab me.
She trips as well, she cuts herself, and she almost falls unconscious, but the three women should struggle up the fountain.
I'm guessing Pink is carrying my unconscious body.
Yeah, you fall through the portal.
Okay.
Yeah, I can't believe the only damage I took was from falling out of the fountain.
Oops. Damn it, this hurts more than fighting demons.
Oh god, okay. Are we out?
Yeah, you feel the same sensation, the warmth envelops you, silence, light, and you emerge in a smoky area.
I'm just checking if they're saying that the audio is okay.
Yeah, okay.
It's fine.
In there.
Okay. Ah, okay. Cool, thank you.
Black Jack's asking you to do a dab.
No.
Alright, I'll dab instead. Anyway, you emerge in a smoky place. It seems to be a civilized area. There are buildings with spikes on them. Yeah, there's a lot of smoke. You hear the sound of hammering. You're back in the lower ward.
We made it back, you guys. You're back in the lower ward, the industrial sector.
Yeah, except now we've got to report back to you.
Yeah.
To get our prize.
God, okay. We're beaten, bloody.
Yeah, can we have a rest before
we
head to
this?
Conveniently, the portal has deposited you in front of this one-story stone building. There's a life-size... At first, you were scared by this life-size Grim Reaper made out of bones. With this black cloak that's standing outside, and the Reaper seems to be pointing into the building behind
it. The Reaper's just like...
above the door, there is a sign saying the Grim Journeyman Tavern.
Oh my god. Tavern, that's...
We have no money off tavern, man.
To buy.
We can't sing our ass there.
We can't make our way back to the, from the lower ward to the clerk's ward.
Okay, so let's go to a corner and just sleep a short rest.
Let's go in there and ask them, can we
perform for...
Well, you have no money.
Yeah, we have
no money. Assume that on the way out, you rubbish the cashier.
Oh, at the bar? Okay, yeah, let's do it.
You managed to get scraped together some gold.
Okay.
You scraped together the woman's life earnings of 23 gold pieces.
Well, she's dead anyway.
She's dead. I'm pretty sure we killed her.
How much? 23?
Yeah.
Alright, we're rich again, folks.
Nope.
Well, rich by my standards. I'm a street urchin. $23 is...
I want to be rich.
Okay.
Okay, so let's go in and get a room. Yo.
We have no money. You're keeping the party's money, right?
Yes, I'm the accountant of the group.
Okay.
Or the treasurer.
I just immediately
so you go in, bloody. I'm just lying over Pink's shoulder like a sack of potatoes.
Pink is like carrying you in a very unglam way, she's like just hugging you.
My little baby.
I'm just like lying on your shoulder like you know the way you carry like potatoes. Like.
Which way up is your head? Are you carrying your like just the feet at the top, the head just dangling?
Yeah.
Yes, I am.
The first thing you notice about this grim journeyman tavern is that it's morbidly quiet.
Hey, let's get out of here. Look at this! I don't want to. I am on one health, guys.
The interior is furnished with grey stone. The pillars are made of grey stone. Everyone sitting around the bar is wearing drab colours and they are looking really down.
I get it. Wow, this place is grim.
And the person behind the counter is a woman with shaggy brown hair. She's a halfling. She's a halfling with shaggy brown hair. She's dressed in grey robes, which in your time in Sigil you have recognized to be robes of a dustman, one of the factions. They are the faction that takes care of the dead.
Ah.
So they mend the mortuary in Sigil. They believe that dying is the way to attain nirvana. Getting close, sorry.
They don't start pushing their beliefs on us.
They believe that dying is but a step towards the one true death.
Okay.
They don't kill people, right?
They don't kill people. Okay. That's unnatural because you reach false death. Only through understanding of the Dustman teachings can you reach one true death. They love the undead. So you can see actually two skeletons killing the marks behind them.
Wait, what's the name of the skeleton? Daniel? Is that you, Daniel?
Daniel!
It's Daniel, right?
Was it
Daniel?
It was Daniel.
Yeah.
Alright, so...
So she musters up a smile. It seems to take a lot of effort for her to smile. She's like, hi.
Does she show any particular affection to me? Because I'm also a halfling?
No.
Okay, just checking. Just seeing if she's a little bit speciesist.
She's like...
So I just say hi.
She's like,
can we get a room?
Drinks are gold piece.
Oh, wait, I'm unconscious on myself.
You're
unconscious.
Yeah. She's, you see? One gold piece for the three of you, you can stay the night and breakfast will be served and as well as dinner. And if you're a bard, I assume that you're a bard, performs, you will get lunch tomorrow as well.
Deal.
Wait, not tonight. I'm at one health.
You actually get dinner, breakfast, and a bed and a crappy room, but you get lunch as well if you perform.
Deal. I get out three gold pieces.
So it's
one for the three of you. Pins are cheap.
Yeah. Okay.
Not just one.
Yeah, just one.
Anytime you spend more than one gold piece, it'll be ripped off.
Okay. That seems rude. I don't flip the coin across.
Yeah.
I take it out and I politely pass it to her.
Next, she motions to a table. She gives you a key. This grey dusty key. It's just grey.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just wrap it on myself.
And the food you are served is like potatoes, but they are a little grey.
Oh no, but you're passed out. How are you enjoying it?
Potatoes, bean curd.
Okay, well, take away.
You're shoving it into my unconscious mouth.
I use prestidigitation to make it taste better.
The dustbin bartender just lays a hand on you. And she revives you back 1 point.
Oh, nice. I'm just like in the arms of an angel.
Yes, you are.
she winks to Pink and she's like, You better put on a good performance tonight.
Yeah.
Right. Cool. Okay, so I assume you have dinner, you sing a morbid song for the customer.
Yeah, really sad song.
What's a really morbid song?
Song about death.
The hellhounds? Who let the hellhounds out?
Yeah,
the
hellhounds out.
Yeah, really sad. Like a funeral requiem. Yeah. Yeah. Go to sleep, you wake up. Do you want to stay for lunch or you want to pack your lunch?
Pack our lunch?
Yeah.
Lord Osborne's waiting for us to retrieve his.
Yeah, we should go back to...
Breakfast is oatmeal in water.
That was not worth it.
Sounds delicious. What are you talking about? It's amazing.
Lunch is steamed red with fries.
Yeah, let's not take that.
No,
yeah, I don't mind that.
I want takeaway.
That sounds quite interesting.
Red is edible.
I take some of the poison cheese out of my pocket and I'm like, do you guys reckon I should put the poison cheese which we got from that hell place?
Yeah, yeah, you take out the cheese has turned a sickly red and it's like rotted.
Don't eat that. It seems warm to the touch.
As if you catch on fire at any moment.
I don't throw it in the bar. I go, oh no, and I run outside and I just throw it on the street and then I come back in.
You turn on the street and you see one of the harmonium walk by and he's like,
uh-oh,
one live on season.
Sorry. Does it catch on fire?
It doesn't.
Okay. Is there a bin nearby?
Yeah, there is. Okay.
I carefully put it in the bin and I go back inside.
Alright.
Next day you see the papers. No one what catches fire.
Okay.
So can we?
We're back at full health and everything. Because Bell's everything.
Yeah.
Thank goodness.
So where do you guys want to go?
We need to go to the shelter.
Yes.
Immediately. Okay.
Yeah.
You hit out the.
Yeah, probably should, right? Yeah.
Probably should. You hit out the tavern. You enter the smog of the lower ward, and all of you make constitution check.
The smog.
12 plus 4.
Critical miss. Oh, I get to reroll! Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry.
You better roll above 10.
Oh, yeah.
13.
Okay. All of you cough and sneeze through the smoke, but you manage to shake off the effects. As you walk out of the tavern, you see the Great Foundry, one of the godsmen standing in front.
I'm like, hey!
He comes over, hey, little buddy!
I just burst out crying the tears and I'm like, I lost my ex!
He's gonna hug and comfort you and he's like, that's fine, I can make you a new one.
It's okay, I'm gonna get revenge.
Alright.
Yeah, I whisper to him, she's sensitive about her axe. Don't mention the axe.
Axe, you're a question.
He burst into tears again.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you make sure that axe her wrong. So, you make your way towards, where do you guys?
Question. When we got robbed, was it in the lower ward?
Oh, it was in the hive ward. It was in literally called the hive, the place.
Okay.
Are you thinking we should go get some
revenge? Yeah, can we make a detour
to
see if we can get the scar guy?
I'm game.
I'll wait here.
She'll wait at the lower ward.
I will just wait at the freaking lower ward while you all go kill yourselves. And then I'll pick you up later.
Nothing can just stand still.
I'm happy go lucky, I'm like, sure, let's do it.
Will it be on the way? Because I remember we had to pass through the hive to get somewhere, right?
You can make it along the way or you can take a shorter route. Let me just consult my handy map of Siju. The hive is nearby.
It's nearby?
The hive is nearby.
Cool.
The hive is just one eastwards.
Could I?
Yeah, it's along the way.
It's
along the way.
Okay.
You're gonna
get us killed, yo.
So you can take the longer route past the ladies' spot.
We can take the longer fancy route, which is safer, or the shorter route, which will get me my axe back. It's also very dangerous.
As much as I really like the idea of getting your axe back, I just want to make it clear that these same bandits who we're about to go take on killed all three of us last time. But I'm game.
Anyway, the shelter located in the hive.
Huh?
Oh!
Shelter located in the hive.
Yeah! We gotta go to the hive anyway.
Yeah, but the question is, are we specifically
fine, okay,
looking
let's go
for...
find shelter.
No, yeah. I'm keen.
If it's on the way,
let's go find shelter and ask her if she knows anything about the Crescent Scar guys. Crescent Tattoo guys.
She might like us, given that if we bring back something, like knowledge for her.
Mm-hmm.
Should have given her the cheese, man.
And evidence.
Oh yeah.
No, I've got multiple things. Oh, yeah, cash was one of the things. There was some meat in my pocket too. I haven't thrown it all away.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Money.
Yeah, I've got coins.
24 what is money? Steals it.
Damn it.
Immediately.
It's money now.
Actually, so is the mint getting hot in my pocket?
No. But it's rotten, yeah, it's getting warm. Then
but it has
let's go straight to Shelter. We give her the meat and our knowledge of what that place is.
Yeah.
And then
let's just be there.
And then we ask her if she knows anything about Crescent Tattoo. If she doesn't know anything, fine. If they are her allies,
we can kill them anyway, but we won't tell her that.
Yeah, if they're enemies, we can get her help.
Done.
Okay.
I'm in.
Remember to get the golden rose thing.
Yeah. Okay, we hit the shelter.
Okay, so to walk towards the high, we have to cross the ditch, which is the infamous canal in Sigil filled with sludge.
Mm-hmm.
You have to walk past the Shattered Temple, which is the headquarters of the ASR.
Yeah.
One of the factions, we don't believe in gods, so it's literally a Shattered Temple, it's a broken in temple. These guys believe that all gods are assholes, they renounce all gods, and they make their base in a destroyed temple. So a little bit of history, the Shattered Temple used to belong to a god named Eoska, who decided to take on the Lady of Pain.
Should we write all these on?
No, this is just a bit of background for Sigil. Who decided to take on the Lady of Pain. He decided that he was more powerful. He wanted to come into Sigil and...
had that work out for him.
Yeah, so his temple has been shattered. They do not have many followers left. All the followers prefer to keep it down low. Yeah, they don't go around saying that they are followers of Eoska. Right, as you walk past the shattered temple, you don't see much of the Aesar. They are quite recognizable. They are very bleak. You see that in front of a building, there is this little makeshift podium that has been set up, and there are six Mercy Killers.
Oh.
Mercy Killers?
Mercy Killers are one of the factions. They are the justice dealers in Sigil. They deal out justice. They wear large grey plate armor. They are huge halberds. They believe in basically in exacting justice everywhere that...
So they're like lawful, crimes, neutral kind of thing?
Yeah, anywhere that crime has been committed.
Okay.
So at this point in time, they have a podium set up. There is a man who seems to be about to be executed. Like, he's tied up, and there's this person holding a scroll and reading out his crimes. And you came at the right moment where the person is just starting to announce, and he unfolds his scroll. And you want to stop to witness this?
I want to listen and find out.
I
want to
listen.
Yeah,
we don't want to.
I'm not intervening yet.
It's like those side quests where you're like, do I save this guy or do I just
Fair Eye of the Noble Ward. You are hereby executed for stealing a loaf of bread.
What?
And he rolls up his scroll.
Oh, we're not gonna lame-miss this, guys.
It's
lame-miss.
We can't fight. And he walks away. And the Mercy Killers shove the man onto the stone slab in front of him, and he's like crying.
No. And he's like, I did nothing wrong.
And can three of you make an intelligence check to sort of see your understanding of the laws in Sigil?
Fuck, just now I was rolling it for practice and it was like 15, 18, 19, and then now I rolled like 3. Kind of sad.
Intelligence. This part is stronger.
That's 11, sorry.
12.
The 12 is good enough. You know that. Two of you know that stealing a loaf of bread is not grounds for execution. So this man probably stolen from someone important.
Okay, so how many people are there?
There are 6 Mercy Killers.
We can't take them on.
Yeah, I wasn't going to fight them.
We are not taking anybody on in the hive. You got that?
This
I don't care if anybody is being raped and shit on or whatever.
This is the lower ward where it's safe, except for the demons walking around, but it's safe.
I reckon we should at least try and talk these guys out of killing him.
Yeah, I can ask them who he stole from.
You're very clever, right? Say this kind of thing, then look at me.
You're the one with
the executioner is wearing this black collar, he's reading his text.
Okay.
My charisma is +3, what's yours? +2. Alright.
No, but hers is +6 for persuasion and shit.
Okay. That's true. So, persuasion. Yeah, so we should send in the bard.
Just shove a pink towards them.
Hello, I don't want to be here.
There's like two little people behind you pushing you.
Like you push one leg, I push one leg. Okay, okay.
Just like, 2, 4, 6, 4, 1.
Okay, okay, so we go up there.
And we just like ask the guards, like, so why is this guy getting killed?
And as you walk towards the holy wall, the guards like bristle and brace himself and it's like, and he's like, stop, citizen.
Yeah,
not interfering in our conversation.
You know stealing bread isn't punishable.
Yeah, so,
and they're lawful people, so you can, like, use it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you should be a bard.
Okay, so Pickle's the one talking.
No!
He stole from the harmonium.
Oh, the city guard, right?
Yeah. And the man is like, I haven't had food for 3 days.
Oh my god, it's really...
Yeah, I mean, he really... I mean,
you can tell that he really...
He was...
I step in and go, how much is the bread worth? Would it be okay if I compensated you for his crimes?
To give him a second chance.
I would like to buy this man to a second
resolution.
Release.
Actually, it should be me. It
should be you, but 17 is not bad.
20.
The man seems to be slightly persuaded by your argument. He says, hop, and then he walks back. They have a short consultation, this six-armed man, like grey spiked armor. Just talking amongst themselves, and the man on the sled looks thankfully at you. And they turn back and they say, two copper pieces for the loaf of bread, 50 gold pieces for violating the law.
Oof!
We can't afford
that.
I'm like, you're on your own! And I fall down. Fireball! What do we do, guys?
Can we just persuade them? Just like, this guy is clearly starving.
Yeah.
Don't you guys have any compassion?
Oh, they don't have compassion.
They don't?
Mercy killers. Okay, so the name mercy killer doesn't refer to the traditional mercy killing. It refers to the sense that they are going to kill mercy.
What?
They kill off mercy so that they can exact justice everywhere that it has been trespassed.
Oh jeez.
So it's more gold than we have.
Can I like persuade them and say like he probably has children or wife to feed and he's really hungry.
So we tell them basically what she said.
Yeah.
That like,
so do I roll?
Yeah. It's just gonna create more crime, man.
Persuasion
only, right?
Yeah.
I didn't offer to pay it, nothing for it.
Persuasion
is alright.
Oh, I can just reroll that.
Come on!
Drop it properly.
Ah.
Drop it in the tray!
There we go.
No!
That's why.
It was a 17.
It was a 17.
What do you mean?
Oh, it was a 17?
It was a 17 outside.
Don't count.
It's a one.
It's a critical one.
It says, we do not reason with people.
Okay, but like, if you kill him, his family's gonna be poor and then they're gonna steal some more, so like, you're just creating more injustice.
Yeah, okay, don't execute him, but give him
a lighter
sentence instead.
Give him a sentence. Like, or like...
You're going to fail one last check, okay? At a disadvantage.
Okay.
Oh,
roll.
Pink and roll this. At a disadvantage, so you roll two dice and take the lowest. But you have a plus six to persuasion. Even a one is fine, like, it just depends on what I roll.
Okay. 17 plus six.
About 15.
Plus
15
plus
six.
21.
He seems to understand what you're saying. He goes on a discussion with his pals, and he comes back and says, we will let you decide the man's fate. We agree to go on a fine to 10 gold pieces, or you can have him serve a lifetime sentence in the prison.
So we're buying this guy a lifetime sentence for $10 or 10 gold pieces?
Yeah, pretty much.
Gold pieces is like $200.
Yeah. Can I take a look at the guy and just like, what were you doing before you stole? Like, did you have a job?
Yeah, can we have a chat with him?
Can we chat with him?
Yeah. Do you mind if we talk with him before we... Okay. No.
Do you know what he was doing before this? What made him turn to injustice?
This
crime?
I do not know, but this man was from the hive, so he is calm.
Oof.
Wow. There's prejudice already.
I don't like to be prejudiced.
Can we further persuade him to drop the price?
No, no. So we've got 23, it's half of our, it's more than, just under half of our money.
Slightly worried that if we let him go for 10 gold pieces, he's going to come stab us in the back because he's from the hive. No offense, I am still scarred by that trying to save the girl thing.
Yeah, I know. So yeah. We've been burned once, it's the whole shame on me if we
should be better people.
We should be. I like to be a positive force in the world.
Yeah, we'll give him the 10 gold pieces.
What the hell? Nobody consulted me. Let's go, guys! Let him rot in jail.
So we're gonna. So I'm about to give the 10 gold
pieces. I'm like, no. No.
Because we handle both 10 gold pieces.
No, you don't.
Okay, yeah, I can't fix the 10 gold pieces. Yeah. Everybody's dismissed. You are free to go.
Yeah.
And the man comes out and says, Thank you.
The man, is he still bound? Can he still be bound?
He's still bound.
Okay.
You want to keep
I'm just
him
gonna
bound?
Grab him by the neck and I'm just like, don't waste this chance. We're giving you a second chance right now. Go find a proper job. If you need one, we can help you maybe ask around, but like.
We'll be a housekeeper in our house. We need to see if we can do it another one.
No, we don't.
I think we should go get
I don't
him.
Know
food
how
man.
We pay.
Food.
What's the name?
Food, yeah.
Food man.
He says, I'm a simple rat picker. So I pick up garbage and dead
so
bodies and ship them off.
To
rat picker square.
I'm guessing it's not very profitable seeing as you have to steal.
Yes. I have to take care of 4 children.
My god, stop having so much then.
stop breeding.
Yeah.
For me, it's a pay it forward thing. I'm happy as long as he's.
Yeah, but I want him. I want to make sure, like, impress on him that, like,
don't mess
this up. You have a second chance.
Are you threatening him or persuading him?
I'm threatening him.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
He understands. He hears you loud and clear.
Okay. And then we,
cause you cost us 10 gold pieces of meth.
I'm just like we just wasted our entire group savings on you. We have nothing left. I say this very early. We have nothing. Left,
then I
saved
nothing.
Thank you. I'll find a way to repay you somehow.
Okay, and yeah, we continue on.
Okay.
10 gold pieces.
On we go. On you go. For me, I'm like, easy come, easy go.
Okay.
10
so,
gold pieces?
Yeah, and
so
then
now
we are down to 13, right?
Yes, 13.
Right. Yeah, but everybody thinks we have zero, hopefully. Yeah.
Everyone else thinks
we're just
so you're heading towards the hive?
Yeah, we meet Shelfthal.
Okay, you cross the smelly ditch, you enter the hive. Where is it? So again, it's a messy place, there are beggars. I assume that you're not going to stop tonight.
Yeah, no. One of those things the horses wear, their eyes? Yeah.
Blinkers,
yeah. All of you are wearing blinkers, guys. No.
Right. Just marching through the hive, then you see like, after you remove the blinkers, you see like 20 stars, yeah.
So wrong. I put them back on.
Yeah, we hit the shelter's place.
This is funny. Really, you make your way through the hive without much incident. You make it through that.
I'm keeping an eye out for crescent tattoos.
You don't see any of them. You have a feeling that they don't themselves that often.
Okay.
Then you make it to the hive. You go back to the group cluster 8 buildings.
Yep.
Where Shalda's lair is located. Now it's daytime, so a few of them have guards standing outside. They seem to recognize you and they just back
up
you.
Thank
you to
God.
Your friend Roger is still there. And
yeah, I was like, hey.
Do we see that pool of water with the.
No, that's underneath. We have to go down the.
Oh, we haven't gone there yet.
Yeah,
they motion you through to that trap door. You hit down.
Climb down.
Yeah, you see one of the guards throwing like food. To the slimes in that cavern on the.
Dude, we are like BFFs already, we're so tight with these.
I don't
guys,
think so.
Yeah.
Guys.
Okay. As you go down, the two guards just motion for you to come in and they lead you to the cavern with the podium where Shalfa is giving a speech. And she's giving a speech about tearing down the shackles of the factions.
Oh, anarchist.
Yeah. And she stops and she says, "Gentlemen, our friends have returned.
Yeah.
I shall end my speech today. Come, come.
Okay.
She motions you guys into the room with the locked trinkets. And she's like, so, where did that portal lead you to?
Okay. So it was this really weird place with like a red sky and then this town and then there was a fountain and then...
Name, please.
Nostrum.
Nostrum.
I have not heard. There is no such place.
Yeah, that's why we were describing it to you right now. If you could let us finish.
What use were you to me if you went through the portal?
Do you want us to describe what
and
happened?
You can't tell me the name of the plane.
Nostrum!
Nostrum is not a plane.
It's a place in the plane.
How about we describe the place to you
How
and then...
How about you go in there again?
We describe the place to you and then you can figure out the plane from there. Because there was some funky stuff going on, just saying. We're not super smart, we don't know, but maybe you know, since you've traveled the plane so much.
Fine, but I will need to consult a scholar on this to find out where the plane is. He will
actually,
have...
will we know what plane?
No. Okay. He will have fees. You will need the food.
Oh my god, woman.
Everyone wants money.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Okay, we
transaction
just...
is 10 gold pieces.
I'm trying to negotiate.
Yes, see guys, we could have used this tango piece.
No, it's okay. We still got some, but I'm like, surely
okay,
given your...
Okay, describe the place first.
Well,
okay.
Surely given your prowess in this town, you're able to get discount prices or better prices than that?
Don't talk so much.
Yeah, we just take it back from Osborne.
So,
okay.
After a while, you see the man that rescued.
Walk into the
room and he's like, my saviors!
Oh, he's your person?
And then he's like, this is a little bit embarrassing. I am quite learned about the planes, but I prefer to keep a down low because people...
You said you were a rag picker.
I am a rag picker and a scholar of the planes.
Wow.
Awesome. How convenient.
And he insists to shout out, these are my friends. Let them have my service for free. Hooray!
Well, technically we paid for it. Oh my god, such a bitch.
And this is for Blackjack Project. This is for Blackjack Project Horizon. He pulls out 3 colored eggs.
Oh?
Yeah, nicely painted eggs. And he says, this is yours.
Ooh.
As gratitude.
I take one of them.
Yeah.
What color are they?
It's like an Easter egg. It's painted in
the
colors.
It's because black
dead. Yeah, and...
Yoink. Great. I
you
got
feel that you can just sell it for fetching some, or you can try and discover what it's for.
We
you,
keep it.
And you keep it in your pocket.
Yeah. Make sure we don't do that.
Damn it.
Safe.
You hear this crunching sound. It was safe.
So do you want to describe the place to the scholar?
Yeah, okay, we describe the place.
Terai of the Lower Ward.
Is that his name?
Yeah, Terai. T-H-E-R-I-A-I.
T-H-E-R what?
A-I.
T-A-I.
That's the guy's name.
Yeah. You okay?
Yeah. That's the book. Scholar.
What does he look like, by the way?
Well, we know he's impoverished.
He's old
and
skinny.
Old. When you first met him, he had like black hair, all scraggly, and he was dressed in rags. Now, his hair is still scraggly, but he has made some effort to push it down. He's dressed in a brown robe, which you recognize it to be one of the collector's robes. Collectors are people who wander around the hive picking up trash and dead bodies. And they ship it somewhere which you do not know where they ship it.
Oh, so he is
the rag picker. Yeah, he's the rag
picker. He didn't lie.
So,
aren't you glad we saved him now?
He's like,
no, we, you guys gotta understand, we paid for his
services. But if we hadn't paid for his services, we went back to Shalta, she would be like, this is useless, my
guys. And you got all these nice Easter eggs.
Yeah. Easter eggs.
Hey, thank you, Easter eggs. Okay.
Not really. Okay.
Look, you've got my teddy bear.
Okay. Yeah, and you're never getting it back.
I steal her Easter egg. Okay.
You
okay?
So he's like, tell me about the place.
Okay. Creepy red sky, but the town looked fine. There's a fountain in there that had like this circle thingy with like exactly in half black, half white, and like
everyone had these creepy smiles on their faces, and like,
what else was that?
Red sky. Yeah, the lights of a magical nature, and then like the place was called Nostrum. What else? There was an inn called the Demon's Hoof.
There was a
yeah, the plate thingy, right?
Missing out an important detail.
Oh yeah, so at night the people turned into these pig demon thingies.
Demons, you
yeah.
Say.
So like,
can you describe them to me?
Okay, green looks like a monkey upright on two legs, but has a face of a pig. And then
you survive a fight against a dretch.
Oh, they call it dretch?
Yeah.
How do you spell it?
It's one of D-R-E-T-C-H. It's one of the lesser demons. Are there other demons that you fought?
Yeah. Weird looking, this slime looking dudes, they're like big and like kind of slimy.
Those are manes.
How do you spell it?
M-A-N-G-S. Yes. So these are lesser demons. What I can tell is that these were probably petitioners. So petitioners are people who have died, and they are sent to either whichever plane matches what they did in life. So if you're a good person, you go up to the heavens. If you're an asshole, you go to the abyss in the nine hells. So he says, Red Sky, it seems that you were tossed into one of the many layers of the abyss.
Okay.
I can't pinpoint the exact location, but I would say it's one of the lower levels. Maybe one of the 400-ish levels. The abyss is infinite. There's an infinite number of levels.
Okay, how about, we saw this angel structure.
Oh yeah, the angel
statue. It was a deva.
Yeah, it's a statue of a deva.
It was probably an illusion.
No, yeah, so at night,
travelers to stay at town.
Yeah.
And
at night, the statue, the torso was gone.
And then there was a fountain that...
It was probably an illusion that was broken. So there was a portal back.
Yeah,
right.
The portal appears.
It's like Shao Sa is like,
okay, what else? There's no animals at that place too.
Yeah, there were no animals, no kids. And the entire thing had a palisade around it that was like unbroken.
Okay, yeah, so he guessed that it's more than 400-ish layers of the abyss.
Okay. Is that enough for you, Shelter?
Oh, yeah. Okay, alright. Then she dismisses...
Gold rose, please.
Say, right. Your service are not needed anymore.
And again.
It's like, you have kept your end of the bargain. Do not come trudging around my grounds again. She goes in, she takes the gold rose and she flings it at you.
Catch it.
One last thing, just teeny little question before we go.
He should go out first. I should stand at the door and then you ask her, and then I'll cast invisibility and she gets all stuff.
Okay. Do you know perfection with like a crescent tattoos on their faces?
Crescent tattoo, bunch of thugs.
Yeah.
Yeah. They are the Crescent Moon. The Crescent Moon gang.
I love how creative you guys are with your names.
Why else would they pick a crescent?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay, so anything else that you
know
about them?
So do you know anything about them?
Yeah. I can tell you where the hideout is. Who?
Ho, hey, ho.
Yeah,
do you like them? Do you wanna fight with them?
I have no quarrel with them, but one less gang that is preying on people in the hive means my anarchists are safer to roam the streets.
Wanna help us?
Oh no.
But I know you don't want to accompany us on it.
But could you send some help?
Yeah, is there any way that you can
aid
us in any way?
I have no quarrel with them.
Okay.
And you have a golden rose now, and you have additional help from me in the form of information.
Sure.
So get out before.
Where's the hideout, man?
Yeah, where's the hideout?
All right.
She tried to snipe us like that. I'm watching you, woman.
Find a derelict building to the east of the Gatehouse Night Market.
Derelict building to east of Gatehouse Night Market, right?
Yeah. So the Gatehouse, you know, is where the Big Cabal sets up their base. But the Big Cabal is a faction which believes that life has no meaning.
Oh my god, relatable.
Yeah. and they run this place called the Gatehouse. The Gatehouse is an asylum for mad people.
Right.
Which is very suitable for them. And the night market is a little bit to the north of the Gatehouse. It's literally a night market where they sell like stolen goods and shit.
So the Gatehouse and the night market are close to each other, and the derelict building is to the east of it.
Yeah. And with that information, she dismisses y'all and...
I wanna know what's in the eggs. Is it just an egg? Can we... shake it?
Chocolate.
Yeah, they're made of chocolate.
Oh!
You can eat them.
I've still
You said they're worth money though.
Yeah.
You can either sell them or you can eat them. They restore 1d6 hit points when you eat them.
Okay, we are keeping them.
Wait.
I've still got canned.
shit!
Because I stole it before.
Okay, fine. You carry it.
Yeah, so Blackjack, you ask the eggs contain chocolate, they can eat them and you kill them. That's the suggestion. Happy Easter!
Nice!
Alright, that's all. Thanks for watching, guys.
Yay.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.